All right. Well, we are back, huh? We're back at the Nine Club Experience, everybody. Episode 116.
Yeah.
Do you ever get tired of just saying that?
No, because I get excited and then nothing happens. You see? It's just quiet. Like, nobody else is excited except me. Like, and it should be the other way around.
You know what's funny, though, is when you do that on the other show and you start opening up like that, watching the guest face is so funny.
Oh, dude. Jamie Thomas was sitting there fucking like, he was like dying laughing.
Yeah.
And I'm like, it's pretty funny. And I'm watching him laughing and I'm just trying to do the intro.
It's turning into a life of its own here, Chris.
Yeah, I know. But Jamie Thomas, man. Wow.
Wow.
What a dude.
What a changed dude. Man.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Not like he was a bad dude.
No.
He just had a different work ethic back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, different work, how he ran a company.
Mm-hmm.
So many good things in that episode, man. Yeah. Wow.
So yeah. Good.
He was talking about how to do proper front crooks, proper front feebles, like running the Chris Cole back on zero, how that whole thing unfolded. It was great.
I love when we talked about the video parts, when he was talking about... like, you don't need to do video parts, but video parts give you, like, respect, basically. Yeah. You know what I mean?
When we were talking about the newer kids, do they need video parts? Are they Instagram skaters? How does that work, right? And he was like, well, video, you need respect.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I was like, totally well said on that.
Yeah. Did you talk about Dylan?
Yeah. That's, yeah.
I've got to watch that one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was amazing, man. Jamie Thomas. Go check that out, man. Stop and chat.
Definitely.
But we have, you know, man, one of our good friends of the Nine Club, friends of all of us, man, and just amazing dude passed away last week. Heath Hufnagel is a shock to a lot of the industry. And some people knew that he had, he passed away of brain cancer.
Mm-hmm.
Some people knew, some people didn't, and it was quite the shock. And we're all devastated, man, devastated.
Because
he's touched everybody that I know
in
certain ways that I can't even describe, you know.
Definitely. Affected us in one way or another, you know. I mean, I used to be on DVS with him, so I definitely got to travel with him quite a bit. And I mean, the humility and the grace that he carried as a skateboarder, not only as a skateboarder, but a businessman, I mean, carried weight, man.
Yeah, I traveled with him on Stussy, too,
back
in the day. Yeah.
Sick.
Traveled with him and then golfing.
Yeah, like, obviously, golfing as well.
It was just, man, it's horrible.
Yeah,
it's a huge loss for skateboarding.
I've never heard one bad thing about him at all, ever.
No.
Yeah.
You know, is this the nicest dude when you see him? And when you hear about him, it's always good things, you know?
Totally.
Buscemi posted something the other day, and it was a clip from when Huff Glasses came out, and the clip was like Buscemi, like him giving Huff giving Buscemi the glasses, and like Buscemi just took his glasses off and threw them on the floor. And then Keith like laughed and went and got his glasses off the floor. You know what I mean? Like,
they're probably some expensive glasses. Buscemi, they ain't some random, like 7-Eleven glasses.
Right. Yeah. And I thought that depicted everything. It was like Buscemi didn't give a fuck about whatever he was doing later.
Right.
Huff glasses on, but Huff was like, holy shit, you just threw your glasses off the fucking, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
man.
It was just so cool.
Yeah,
such a good dude.
Yeah.
So sad, man.
He will be truly missed, man.
He will.
Yeah.
It's just it's devastating, you know. Somebody, we lose another skater. It's
2020 has not been nice shape or form.
But we have a bunch of Huff clips. Thought it'd be rad to go through some Huff clips and stuff like that. We have, this is from, Skatemore, the DVS stuff, Dubs. Nice. You were in that, right?
Dude, both your guys' part was awesome in this video, dude.
It's a fun video to work on.
That view is insane, the side view.
I know.
It was like nuts.
Nuts.
Dude, he was like the first skater that I saw when I was a kid that I literally wanted to dress like that dude. Mm-hmm. Like, he skated, he obviously stood out because of his style was so sick, but the way he dressed, I was like, I watched this old footage of me, I literally look exactly like him. I had like a red t-shirt, some faded blue jeans and some Howard 2s on, and I was like, that's the most Keith Hufnagel outfit back then, you know?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
I loved Tony Hawk, his post. he like had said like something about just like something about the simplicity of the ollie and how he can just, that was just like he made that his and everyone watched and it was, you know what I mean? Like it's such a beautiful thing when you think about it like that, you know what I mean?
Totally.
Everybody ollies, but not like Keith Hufnagel. Like
Keith Hufnagel. Dude, he owned that for sure.
He made basic tricks look beautiful.
Yeah.
You know, it was amazing to watch.
Yeah.
Dude, Barracks just posted something of the manual, ollie manual at the library in San Francisco. Just even that, just like the amount of power, speed, control, and just grace you have to have to do that.
He did a bunch of those ollie manuals, but then he'd pop out so lovely. Right. So lovely.
Yeah.
Like, and his shoulders, his arms are always like down. Like, you know, like he had that really cool style.
Super nonchalant style.
I mean, I would like to believe that, like, I don't know, watching this shit, like, you wouldn't, if it wasn't for Keith, you wouldn't have the Brandon Westgates. You wouldn't have the... the Nike...
Grant Taylors.
Yeah. You wouldn't have them if it wasn't for Keith Hufnagel.
Yeah.
He definitely paved the way for a lot of people.
For sure.
Oh, man.
And helped so many, man. Like, it's just like... not get it twisted, he definitely helped move forward on a lot of people that he saw potential in, and you know, I've seen various people just be like, thank you for everything you've done for me, you know, whether you knew it or not, you know, it was very really really rad, man.
Yeah, his legacy definitely lives on through all of us, but there's so many, like Louis Elliott, his post was such a such a beautiful thing, because I remember seeing Louis as a little kid coming up under Huff's wing, and you know, to see what these kids that he kind of gave a lot of life to have turned into as adults, it's a testament to his love and just how much he cared for people.
For sure.
Totally.
Because they carried that. They carried that energy with them. You know what I mean? I mean, it just goes to show, like, you know, once you get recognized by one of your peers, especially if you're Keith Hufnagel, like, that speaks volume. You know what I mean? And those kids, they felt it, and they felt the energy that he brought forth to them. And like I said, it's speaking volume on, you know, on many ways right now, especially on social media. You know, it's been very, very amazing to see everybody post and just, you know, show that love, man.
Yeah.
Dude, these clips are incredible, dude.
So good.
I'm getting lost watching them. Like, wow. That backside flip, switch Manny, when it's here, his arms, like, when he lands, he's like, I just did the sick
because
things.
Seriously, because the way you got to turn and carve in for that is awkward for that position on that ledge, you know, and he made it so graceful.
I feel like back in the day too, you're like, this guy, all he does is ollie, and then all of a sudden he just does this shit, and you're like, this guy does everything. Yeah. Like,
no, it's just a part of his arsenal of tricks.
Dude, a lot of people, there's a lot of tricks that he would do that other people couldn't pull off. You know what I mean?
For
like, like he would do like 180, 50, 50s, and I don't, like, I would see people don't really do that trick, but he made that look extra amazing.
Right.
Yeah. You know, you had to be him to do it.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. It don't work for everybody.
Yeah, it don't work for everyone, you know?
That was
so sick. Man, what a dude, man.
Dude,
that was massive.
Because that one's bigger than the other one, right? There's two different sizes of the gaffs.
There's one that's definitely bigger.
Yeah, there's three benches in a row, right? Yeah. Is it three or two?
There's three.
Three.
And there's one of them is smaller than the other gaff. I think there is three. But he always made lip slides on ledges look so cool.
And that's a scary one, because those things get slick.
Oh, yeah.
That marble.
You throw some wax on there, you're later.
Yeah.
Wow.
And you can't go slow for that.
Mm-mm.
And that one is quick, is smaller too, so it's quicker to ollie and then do it.
Ollie up, yeah.
Jeez, dude.
Yeah.
And he's just chilling too.
Man. He had it. He had it. And then we have, this is... Real, the nonfiction real video.
Oh, that part's awesome.
So good.
That was like,
look at that.
Because that's not a trick you normally see him do, but not he did it so good, dude.
Like, that's what you're so rad. He's like, I did that later. Not doing it again. Did it already.
He's got the bleach blonde hair.
Bro.
Oh, dude. Yeah, the hair.
That's proper as fuck.
Man. Dude, so good.
That
ain't easy.
No.
Mm-mm.
Is that Black Rock?
Mm-hmm.
So that's like the sculpture there, right?
Yeah.
Right. And you can't skate that anymore, or could you?
I don't even, is that thing still there? I mean, I haven't been to SF to see the, like those landmark spots in a minute.
Because that just looks...
I would figure they skate stop that thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to ollie up pretty...
It is hot. Is it tall? Like, it's weird. I can't really see where...
It's at least over knee height, I think, to get on. Jeez.
Ollieing up onto a bank, doing a trick that good.
I don't think you've seen anybody else do anything on that, right?
No. But I always love the bank tricks where you go up, you do the trick, and then you go back down. Some people like stall a little bit once they do it. They stall and they come back down. This is the way you do it.
Yeah. The backside That's flip the you that it. You showed earlier.
Yep. Yeah, flowy.
He like just, it's like uses the bank.
Yes.
Rat, it's like, crazy, yeah, when you land.
On that little metal thing. Yeah. Yes, yeah.
When you land, like having speed into it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like
that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like that's what you got. That's the way to do it.
Dude, he had so many good backside flip on banks, man. Dude, that rail. Sketchy.
Most humble Amazing. Dude too. So, like was just you wouldn't know that he made a lot of money off of his businesses and shit. Like he was just
totally
quiet as kept.
Yeah. Quiet as kept.
Straight up.
Bro, those Huff socks.
Dude.
Yeah, the weed socks.
Oh my God. That thing's killed it for a hot minute.
Dude. I didn't want to
bring
it up.
I'm sure they're still killing it.
Yeah.
I'm sure they are. So many people bit though. That Vero flip right there, it was incredible.
He did the shallow kickflips, didn't he?
Vario flips were sick.
Spark, it is a shove it kickflip.
That's great.
Everything about this line was
right. Crazy.
He's just cruising, exactly. Dude. It's every clip he gets. It's just he's cruising, man. Yo, that film almost missed that right there.
I'm almost surprised he wasn't on the camp.
Oh, girl and chocolate.
Dude, there was there might have been talks when the chocolate thing was coming around, but I'm not sure.
He fit it.
Totally. He definitely
he
is.
He was already like so real. It was just like he's.
Seems like a really loyal dude, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Look how high that is.
I know.
Wow. Look at that. He almost.
He's literally like at the top just holding like.
He almost nose grinded the top of that.
He could have sat down up there and just took a break.
Yeah.
Man,
dude, the style, bro.
He's had great video parts throughout the years, but I think every time I see Keith footage, I just think of Strictly Roots.
Oh,
that
yeah.
one song. That's ingrained in my head.
So good.
Oh my God.
It's a great song.
Was that Penal Code?
Yeah.
FTC video?
Yeah, it was Penal Code.
Yeah, that video was like pretty much like all stars in that video.
Seriously.
That video is incredible. It's got the Rick and the Mike part at the end.
Mm-hmm.
You got Julio part. You got Huff.
This footage is
good. This video. Good. FTC made great. They made good videos.
Yeah.
Well, Mesa did that.
Okay. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
This stuff is from, these clips are from Roll Forever. Real.
Classic.
Right.
Dude, I always trip on the filmers how they have to skate with them down the street.
That's a task in itself.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm putting my hat backwards due to him right now. That's so sick.
Hell yeah.
Man, Keith Hufnagel, man.
The influence is real.
Yep.
That looks fun.
That's a full Chris Roberts spot.
I would have so much fun. I could nose wheelie that, manual that all day long.
Yeah.
I would definitely try some shit out of it. Probably won't land it.
He would always find those spots that was like just that. You know the one in the Skate More part where he like dropped, we showed early, he drops in a ditch and then he nose mails the top?
Yeah.
That was insane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was super sick.
Oh God, this one.
This one.
Wow, it's beautiful, dude.
Yeah, it's just a little booster.
How do you look at that?
Dude,
wow.
White man can jump.
Yeah.
There's proof.
Look at that.
That's got to feel so fun, too, to just be in the air for that long, just coasting.
Seriously.
So good.
Dude, the ride.
So good.
Oh, feel.
Yes.
So I love that clip so much.
Woo-wee.
So good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he had really good like backslide flips and half cab flips. This flip tricks were on point, man.
Mm-hmm.
Where is this spot?
It looks like Japan.
Yeah, it's Japan. Tokyo, I think. I think that was on a Stussy Tokyo.
That was so sick. Dude, the red shirts. Hard.
Red shirt, red hat. Man. Let's keep going with this, man. Look at that.
Damn, the quick feet. How do you...
That's insane.
That's nuts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How? Dude, he always skated. The spots he skated were always dope. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, the backdrops are pretty gnarly.
Always sick, yeah. Dude.
Oh, this is the one where you manual.
The gap to manual.
Oh, pop. My yeah. God.
Look at that little pop out.
Yeah.
Wasn't extreme. Wasn't like over exaggerated pop out. It was just beautiful.
It was so beautiful.
Dude, I love you when you can tell how fast someone is going by how hard their shirt flaps in the wind.
Yeah. That seriously, it stands out right here.
So good.
Wow, yeah. Dude.
Wasn't windy that day.
Yeah, right. The dismount, man.
I mean, you could get broke off doing that.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Because it's almost, you could probably fly off the end, like, chilling, you know? Like, yeah. If you fell forward.
For sure.
I mean, the hang-up factor, too. It's like,
yeah.
That's the biggest part, yeah.
Yeah.
You're gonna look at that.
Come on, bro.
You have to ollie far and high and then land
and
on
then
the
land in, like, a powerful manual.
Dude, perfect. Not, dude, my God.
I feel like someone like him, like, so many things video doesn't do it justice. Like, yeah. This guy just made shit look super easy and it was huge. You know
yeah.
What I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's so crazy. Totally.
Huff, dude. What a great that's name, too. Oh, Huff, like, that's so sick.
Totally.
So tight.
Oh, since day one, the real video, since day one.
Jeez,
that's not
what?
Easy yeah, at all.
Don't go that way.
Yeah,
I go the other way.
Yeah,
that thing is huge.
Yeah,
that's a ledge on top of a ledge. I always tripped on that thing. Like, why was that there? They just put that there. The skaters
somebody
put it there.
Put it there.
DIY yeah,
it
for sure.
It wasn't, yeah, it wasn't there before.
DIY that for sure.
Little out ledge.
Ooh.
Oh,
jeez.
That's amazing.
Gosh. So fluid. Yeah. Didn't pause up there. But
yeah, that was. Oh, this spot is. I don't know if you guys have skated that spot. That spot is hard to skate. Thing is,
tray fib.
That was insane.
Where is that at?
It's in San Francisco. Mm. I always remember, I always thought the name was so funny because it's called Sneath Ditch. And you just see it like Sneath, S-N-E-A-T-H. I was like, what a random ass
name.
Ditch.
Fucking Sneath Ditch. But they made a lot of like DIY spot like there. They put like a quarter pipe there and then that thing was a super, super tough to skate.
Man, I used to run his DVS shoe.
Oh yeah,
so hard, bro. Mm-hmm.
The what's the high top one?
The one with
it's a one, the white one with the little stripes around it.
Oh
it was
yeah,
like a whole. Yeah. It was yeah. A bigger. It was a boat.
Kind of a yeah, pointy a toe.
Did it have a pointy toe? I remember know. It was a moon boot. No.
It was bulky. Big.
That thing
it
was bulky. Yeah. It was big. But I loved it.
Yeah. Now I'm thinking of I think the day ones had the pointier, like it had a sportier look. But the I'm trying to remember the low top. I remember the highs though. Mm-hmm. Those always stood
yeah,
out
those ones
to me.
Stood out for yeah. A minute.
That trick is really tough. Like, it seems simple, but it's really not common either to yeah. Do it, you know? Mm-hmm. Only person I remember doing it is, like, Kenny Anderson.
Yeah, he does it really
oh,
well.
Yeah,
yeah, he does it proper, too.
The gap to 180 manuals are super sketchy. The slip-out factor.
Mm-hmm.
The low ones, too, where you're just, like, it's you don't go up onto something.
Yeah. Damn. Is that where... So that's a Golden Gate Bridge, obviously, but like, that thing is a perfect bump over that bar.
Yeah, I've never skated that spot. I don't know where that is.
It looks like a quick bump, too.
Kalis, isn't that where the cover was?
There was a cover there.
Yeah, I think it was Kalis.
Is it on that spot? Does he use that bump or is it just awling over it?
I don't know. I don't remember.
I've never skated that spot. And it looks so
it's
good.
An awkward angle, it looks
like. Yeah, he had to come from the.
Oh, yeah, he did it off the side, not
straight.
That spot might, I mean, I don't want to say it's not there anymore, but you don't see much footage of it there.
I don't think it's that easy to skate.
Yeah.
Look at that. Even if it's like.
Dude, look at that form.
Dude, so, and just, it's so scenic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So good.
Like when people are shooting photos of the spot.
Right.
Yeah. Of the bridge.
Such a good one.
Dude, it's push, dude. Oh,
this one. I think this was his last trick.
Yeah. Oh, that thing is huge, dude.
Yeah.
It didn't look huge.
Yeah.
He made it look nice.
So fast. Again,
check the shirt flapping.
Yeah. Dude, those guys are.
Wait a minute. That's a car length almost.
Oh, it is.
It's damn
sure.
near a car length long. That car was backed up a little bit more.
Dude.
Yeah, he looks small compared to the car.
You have to go as fast possibly as you can go. But the crazy part on that too is that sometimes people say it, but like alling up that thing, going that fast.
It's not small.
No, not at all. Yeah. These are tall.
Yeah.
I've never gone that fast in my life. Dubs. Never. I think we covered it last episode. Maybe if I was late for the bus, I would have.
Yeah. That's the only time. That's the only time.
I love the pop out though. The manual, just nice pop out.
Boop.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I don't like it when people pop out. I just think it looks overdone.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, you got to the end and now you're just trying to
make it
just a little something, you know?
Because some people, when they don't pop out, it looks nice. You just fucking
drop off. Right.
It's a manual. Yeah. Done.
It's to the end.
He made it look.
Because a lot of people use their like body to, they're like, I'm going to snap out. Like they bend down while they're manualing and try to do it. He just kind of like. Just does it.
Yeah. You know? The end of
it's
the
not
trick.
Even an after, yeah. It's not an afterthought for him. It's just natural.
Natural, right. Yeah. Natural alley out that thing.
Like, that's the only way he's doing it.
Exactly.
Oh, this one is, reel to reel. Reel to reel.
Oh, that part is awesome. That song he skates to.
Those
are
the shoes I was thinking of.
Oh, yeah.
Those were the day ones, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's like more of like a runner.
It's a little athletic. Yeah. Yep.
The red shirt.
He ran it.
He did.
Dude. Have you guys, I'm sure you skated there, but have you guys skated the Brooklyn Banks?
Yeah, I definitely skated that for sure.
Those?
I never really got anything. I was one of those, we just skated it and kept it moving type deal.
Did you ever skate the bump over the wall?
I didn't. I've skated it, but I never really attempted to film anything.
You ollied it?
Yeah, I definitely ollied it.
Dude, because that thing always looks so hard to skate.
It didn't look like it had enough to actually like throw you up.
Right? It's a booster.
It just looked like an odd bump, but like if you skated it, obviously you could do some sick shit on it. But
such a what? The bump one, over the wall?
Over the
broken bank?
Costin switch heel.
Oh, okay.
A lot of people did shit over
Nolly back heel.
Nolly back heel.
Kalis fucking
everybody.
Murdered that
Jamie down. Thomas. Oh, Jamie Thomas? No.
Yeah, he did the long ass line
Mike
there.
Mike V. Oh. Ollied and knocked the top a little gate off of it.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Yeah. Look at that fucking clip.
Crazy. Dude. Oh, that one was sick.
Downtown LA.
Yeah.
Very steep bank.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very steep.
He made that look very easy.
I've gotten coffee in there before. Walked right past it. Walked right past it.
Dude, that's the thing. Somebody said earlier, I don't remember who it was, but you have to go to the spots to realize how difficult they are. Because walking by this, you're like, how's anybody ever skated that? Because it doesn't look that steep on camera, but you go there and you're like, oh my God.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's it. I said it, but simplicity of his skateboarding, what he skates is fucking gnarly. You're gonna ollie something, Keith is gonna ollie the fucking gnarliest shit. Right. If he's gonna backside flip on a bank, the shit's gonna be steep as fuck.
Yeah.
And he's gonna do it well.
He's gonna do it amazing.
And make it look so
like
effortless.
It's
like
nothing.
It's,
you can
make
go
look,
there.
Make it look like you can do it.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
And then you get there.
And you're like, I don't think
like, you're calling Roberts. Where's this cafe con leche around here?
Make a left. Tell the doorman that I sent you.
He also ollied that channel thing there.
That's right.
There was like a bank to bank thing.
Yep. Yeah.
Fernando's tacos.
Yeah. Dude.
Woo!
Damn, look at that.
Meanwhile, gap in the UK.
Gnarly.
Jeez, dude.
Are those the shoes?
Those are the day ones, right?
Day ones. Did he even wear his old shoes?
He skated.
I'm telling you, man, those shoes were so good.
I've seen some clips of him. I've seen more clips of you skating him, I think, than
I'm trying to think. I can't hard, remember the bro. Shoes.
They were white with like these kind of blue like stripes around it.
Yeah.
They kind of like went up. I can't remember. I'll have to pull a picture of them.
They were a good looking shoe.
This
this was the one I was about to bring this up.
Tray flip lip.
That is insane.
I couldn't remember if it was in reel to reel or not, but dude.
You did that shit so proper.
So good.
Yo, what? Yo, that thing is so sketchy. I don't that trick is sketchy to me for sure.
I never really fuck with that thing.
Yeah.
The spot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, me neither.
The trick is obviously amazing. That definitely wasn't not talking about that.
He did that absolutely perfect.
Sketchy ass trick.
Dude.
Dude, I always trip on just committing on that thing.
You're right. It's just commitment.
Yeah.
Yeah. He always did land with his hands down, huh?
Yeah.
Just kind of nonchalant.
Dude. Yeah, that definitely.
Like, yeah, that's, he has that. Like,
this one's sick. Dude, this is
nuts. Lip slide.
But, like, you know, nobody does that shit there.
Yeah. Mm-mm.
Like, it's nothing, too. Like, just
hopping.
Like, do you know how hard that is?
Those things are big, too.
Yeah.
I was just about to say that.
And it's not enough. It's not a lot of riding room.
No, as soon as you land, you got to be ready to ollie again, pretty much.
Man. Like, so yeah, he skated amazing.
Look how high he ollied. You could put a trash can standing up right there.
You really could.
He really skated so many spots differently than everyone else, you know?
Oh, UCLA. Oh.
Dude, I went by there the other day. Those things are gone, but that was some quick foot action right there. Mm-hmm. I remember like at Trans World, he got smoked on that thing. Like his fingernail fell off or something.
Oh, really?
I remember there was a clip of him like showing his hand at that spot, like he fell.
The ground was not too forgiving over there, huh?
The gaps don't look small.
No. The 180 was buttery, so dude.
And the fact that he doesn't have to move his foot back to, like, his foot is over the bolts when he ollies both of those, and it doesn't faze him at all.
Like, look at that. I would be really uncomfortable.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. With my foot right there, Dubs.
He's trying to set up again.
Like, oh, God.
Yo, you could get really served on that.
Definitely.
And then to 180 with your foot that close up to the nose too?
Yeah.
That's insane.
But it's like a perfect 180.
Perfect.
Not just a drop down 180. I'm still going to blast if I'm going to another bend.
Yeah, straight up.
Look how far he got. We're talking one board. Two.
Easily cleared 6 feet.
Oh, yeah.
Easily. Four. Another trash can.
Another trash can.
Hey, the red shirt.
Those were some good days, man. The DVS days.
They were fun.
In the height of the DVS.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, so sick.
Oh, man.
Wow.
What a stylish backpack.
And see, ran those shoes so heavy. That's why those automatically stuck out in my mind.
That would have been a great still. Did anybody shoot that still? Look at that. Would have been so sick.
Dude, with the,
look at that sculpture in the background. What is that?
Like a chain looking?
Looks like a bunch of badonkadonks.
That's a
high. Is that the shit you're talking about, Chris?
Nope, that's still the day one.
Yeah.
He probably ran the day one harder than
that's
ran
kind of what I'm feeling.
Shoe.
Yeah.
That sounds about right for this dude.
Right?
He's just like,
rep over the people's shoes.
Yeah. Yo,
yeah, the DVS team back then was insane. Yes, dude. That spot is so jacked.
Oh my God. That spot is the worst.
It's literally the worst. Did you ever get anything on that? What did you, nollie heel?
Nollie heel, yeah.
That was in the DVS video, right?
That was in DVS video. Yeah. Did I do anything else? I think that was it.
I went there. That was one of those spots. Where I'm going to go there. I'm going to try this. And I go there. I was like, oh.
Yeah. Not so much.
I ended up getting a clip on it, but like way later. But that thing was not easy.
This is the ollie of the car wash bank.
That's gnarly.
So gnarly.
And it's like so, the bank is so short.
So
like,
yeah.
I love how he was talking the curl tap thing. He was like, Retta. He's like, yeah, that little kid. I fucking made that little kid.
That's amazing.
Dude, it was so funny.
Yeah, look at that.
Dude, it doesn't make sense.
I'm trying to think, was that the, because Lance Dawes was
shot
right
that.
There.
Yeah, he yeah. definitely shot that.
But it doesn't look like he's shooting that right there in the background.
Yeah, he's right there.
So I wonder if he did it a couple times.
Maybe he got the photo, then he was watching for cars.
Because wasn't
something?
The photo from this angle? I can't remember.
From behind.
I can't.
It wasn't this angle.
It wasn't that angle.
It was
no.
in front.
I believe so.
Okay, I thought it was this angle. Maybe I'm tripping.
Should be from that angle.
He probably got the photo. Was like, I'm
both.
Good.
Maybe he got both.
Yeah. That's amazing though. When the photographer gets the photo, they're like, oh, I'm good. I got the photo.
Yeah.
I'm chilling.
Yeah. Didn't even land it.
Yeah.
Got it.
Just land it. It'll be fine.
Just go ahead and try to land it.
There was a couple times in my career, like Tiba. He's like, dude, we got it already.
We're all good. He's like, Laker game's coming on soon, man. I gotta go, bro.
Show me the thing. Like, oh, word. Okay, cool.
Oh, this was from Transworld Interface.
Oh, this song, too.
Dude, so, Interface was the jam.
It was good video, man.
He rode down that bank like a roller coaster.
Yeah.
Look right at that. Look how smooth that was.
Yeah, that was smooth.
So good.
Ooh. That's like coming down Viper. Came down Viper and you just woo.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's like surfing, bro.
Yeah,
like dropping in on a wave like that shit.
Dude.
That shit is the ill right there.
And it's one of those, like, you see a lot of people who do tricks into the bank and they kind of catch the lip a little bit. And like, no, what you were saying earlier,
dude.
It's just straight in. Like,
this guy can dance, man.
He can dance.
Like, he landed actually quite.
Yeah.
Far down the bank.
Yeah.
So to speak. Like, look.
Exactly how you should do it.
Yeah. Yep.
Takes the impact to use to. Oh, man.
That must have felt really cool.
Dude.
Look at that. Man, what a legend.
Yeah, that one got me a little teared up right there. A little. That one, that makes me feel good.
I feel like, Chris, that legend word gets thrown around quite a bit nowadays, but this one, it fully stands for this gentleman.
And I agree with you, Steezus, and I don't really throw that word around too often.
That shit looks so fucking
dumb. Like, some people use it like dude.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Like, this dude's footage literally makes you want to go skate. Cause that's what, dude, it's just.
Oh, man.
Just the right away. It's like, oh, yeah, I just did that.
Yeah.
So casual.
Looks humongous.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like,
you can't even. The thing is like, you can't. He probably couldn't even
see it.
Yeah.
He's
blind.
He just sees a ledge. He probably sees like halfway down the ledge and he knows kind of where to go.
And look at like the proportion to his body. Like, that thing's humongous. Look at the fucking little board.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's why I like breaking down these clips, you know. It's you can really see.
This clip is insane, dude.
Dude, let me just ollie up a loading dock real quick.
Yeah, right?
Barely have any time to set up. Yeah, oh my God.
Dude, sometimes when people try to ollie high, like their back foot comes off, you know, and it snaps up there. Like, none of that with Keith, man.
Is that Retta right
there? Little baby Retta.
Yeah.
Told you as
well. I made you.
The grill tab.
There's a photo right there.
Yeah, the crayon couch.
Hey.
Yo, I got that, yo.
Yeah, only he could skate that spot. What the heck? Dude, that is insane. Yeah.
I haven't seen anybody else skate that spot.
Makes it easier.
You'd go there and be like, what are you? This is a spot. Like, what are we looking at here? I don't get it.
What am I supposed to do here?
No. You like put your drink on the fucking thing.
Yeah.
Like, what, do I, little Wait, kid, do I put little it on kid acid yeah. drop off yeah. of this? Yeah. Like, what are we doing?
We're waiting for people. Yeah. Yeah.
Retta put his camera bag on the ledge. Oh, man. All right.
Oh, this is my favorite line.
Yeah, this was sick.
The simplicity of the tricks, but the way he does them, is in his backside flip, dude.
That was great.
Oh, my gosh.
And those are the Howards, right?
Yeah. That's like, when I saw this clip, I was like, I want to look like this dude
with the little with the little chain popping right there.
So sick.
I have to pop my chain for this movie.
Front board is so dope, dude. Oh my gosh, so sick.
Wow, yeah, that's sick.
If he rocked anything, perfect. He made it look cool. Like, just everything looked cool when he wore it.
Well, that's why the Huff brand was so successful.
Yeah.
Because he just had that style. Yeah. He just knew.
I think it was Tony said something like that too, where it was like it wasn't about the profit. It was about the, you know, quality of what he did. You know right. what I mean? Like, he wasn't worried about, as you can tell, he's skating day ones the whole fucking time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like he loved everybody and coming
even,
up.
Yeah. Even yeah. through to the end when, the Melrose Fairfax riots went down and the Hiroshi piece was destroyed in the store. Mm. Middle finger snapped off, but then it left a fist and they put it back up in that way just mm-hmm. to sort of like stand with the movement.
That's
and
like amazing. Things like
that. That was too. Dope. Like, I definitely saw that and respected the shit out of that.
Incredible. That's fucking yep. awesome.
So good.
That's fucking cool.
Yeah. It was really cool.
Man, you will be missed.
Dearly man.
Keith Hufnagel, man.
Dearly man.
It's just, it's really sad when somebody passes like that.
Yeah.
And he was battling it for years, you know, even when he came on our show.
Yeah.
I think he was like a year into it, maybe even more.
Yeah. He's been dealing with it for a while.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Condolences to his family and, you know, obviously kids, friends man. And the kids. Yeah. Like, man.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. Fucked.
Foundation is strong as far as the friends are definitely going to step up and, you know, and do their part. I mean, it's just a natural thing for them, I think. So,
yeah,
it's so far and wide how many people he touched. Like you said earlier, Chris, just his reach.
Yeah.
How many people he touched within skateboarding and outside of it. And just it's a testament to his true power, his soul as just a good human being.
Yeah. He's the man.
Well, he's a dude where you just walk up, you have a little conversation, maybe you met him for the first time and you turn around and walk away and you're like, that dude was dope.
Yeah.
You know, like that's the type of dude he is.
Right.
You just, man. Anyway, you'll be missed.
I'm going to miss you, man.
You missed. Yeah, yeah, for sure. Yeah. Rest in peace, Keith Hufnagel.
Hufnagel.
DBC for life.
Yep. By the way, all the videos, links are in the description. Go check out. Go watch his parts.
Yeah,
it's incredible.
Just do it in the morning because you'll want to go skate right after.
Yeah.
So just be aware that when you watch the parts, you're gonna want to go outside.
Exactly.
Seriously.
Cup of coffee, a little Huff part, and you're good to go. Yeah. You are good to go. So sad. I don't know how to move on from this, Dubs.
Chris, it's a tough situation to be in, man.
I'm just blessed that we had time with him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And not only us, but every skateboarder.
For sure.
You know, he was just in all of our lives, which is amazing.
Yeah. It's funny when we did the Melbourne thing, me and Mel, we were partnered up with Huff, and I can't remember who he was partnered with, but him on the golf course, he wore two gloves. Like, it was just like he did what he did, you know what I mean? Like, it wasn't like he was like trying to be somebody or, you know, whatever the case may be. And he did it. He wasn't trying to, you should wear two gloves.
Right.
You should do da da da. Yeah. Like, he was just like doing him and with the most like just mellowest. Yeah, I don't know, man. That dude was so cool.
Yeah. I didn't even notice that. That's what's amazing.
Crazy. Yeah.
Wow.
It even shines through to the people that he employs. You know, I know so many people that have come and gone through Huff and you know, I've never really had like a connection with him personally, but through a lot of people at the brand, I've rocked the brand for many years and just to have somebody who embodies that, embodies what it is and all the people that he, you know, has working for him with the brand love him so much and love the brand. Like that just shows, you know, you can't force that. That has to. You have to be the heart and soul of something for people to really feel that way about it as well.
No, it carries major, major weight.
Yeah.
You know, the respect was real as far as like that's concerned, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was a trip having him here on the show, man. It was like, he brought his DC jersey. I was like, dude, I don't know if you understand how great this moment is for me right now. Like, I literally like idolized you since I first saw you in a skate video.
The DC Super Tour.
Yeah. Yep. I was like, I thanked him. I was like, yo, thank you for everything you've done. I mean, it made me love skateboarding even more, you know? Mm-hmm. But yeah, he's just, it's incredible, man.
Yeah.
I even, dude, he was wearing this shirt when he was on the show. And I was like, dude, I need to get that shirt. Like, I went the next day and I got the shirt. Like, that dude makes everything look sick.
That's how impactful he was, man. Ah, rest in peace, Keith.
Definitely, man.
You will be missed.
Roll forever.
For sure. Yes.
Yes.
Roll forever. All right. Well, we didn't do the raffle to start off the show. Usually we start off the show, we shoot the shit for a little bit, we talk, we catch up with everybody, talk about peanut butter, refrigerated, unrefrigerated, you know, stuff like that.
Mostly that, yeah.
Mostly that. But we wanted to, you know, jump into the Keith stuff, of course, you know, but we do have a raffle to get to as well. So later in the show, we will pick a winner for the signed Tony Hawk game and signed Street Plant board and Street Plant shirt. So just to remind people, we have the Tony Hawk signed game. We have, he signed the cover there. He signed inside and a Polaroid as well. So we got three. We're going to pick three winners later in the show for that. And the Police Don't Beat My Friends Street Plant Mike Vallely Chris so Pastris board, aka Dune. Look at that. Black Lives Matter. Mike Vallely signed the top of it.
So good.
I love that.
So sick. So three winners later in the show. We'll get this. We'll pick winners for those. That raffle. This episode's raffle going on right now. The donations coming in. People ask, how do I get in the raffle? I'll always ask that. Easy. Donate. Donate in the raffle, in the super chat, while the episode's live, Wednesday night, 7 p.m. The next day, Kelly comes over here, cuts up all every individual little winner, or I mean, entry, puts it in a bucket. Do we get you those scissors?
Yeah, the little ones?
Yeah.
I need like a couple of those.
Okay.
I like using multiple different ones.
Amazon orders late, I guess.
Yeah.
So, take forever.
So that's how you do it. You just enter, you just donate. Donate $1, donate $10. Or you could be a Ryan Kula, donate $100 every time, man.
Shout out to Ryan Kula.
Shout out Ryan Kula.
Shout out Ryan always. Kula. He pays for the show.
He paid, yeah.
Keep everything. The reason why Dubs is here, because Ryan Kula.
Thank you, Ryan.
So this episode we're doing a little differently. We're gonna do a 9 club. Mystery box.
Ooh, I was wondering.
You got a mystery box right over there. You got a mystery box over there. Three winners will pick next week for the 9 club mystery box.
There's some stuff in here. It's kind of heavy.
It's about 12 pounds.
Okay. All right.
Hey, don't judge a book by its cover. Here's the thing.
That I think it's hard to believe, but it actually does happen that sometimes people don't claim their raffles. You know, we've had them sitting back there for months and months and months. We don't, you know, listen, after 30 days, you know, we're
what are we going to do?
Yeah, we're not a storage unit over here. Like, no. we don't have enough room.
Your time has, it's, yeah.
You know
it's
what? That's a new thing, Dubs. Okay. 30 days, raffle. If you don't claim it in 30 days, too bad.
Yep.
How about that, Elder?
That's pretty. Yeah. We got the boxes.
Yo, this thing is heavy, bro.
Yeah.
It's hard to hold up.
9 club mystery boxes. Ooh. You know, I will tell you, there's some boards in here. And like a couple of them may be signed. There's some signed boards.
There's definitely a couple in there.
There's a few. There's a few.
I signed one earlier. It was a Chris Roberts board.
What?
There's a sweater. There could be sweaters in here. There are hats, stickers, grip tape, etc., etc., etc. It's a big box. It's a big box. So three winners later. Next episode, we'll pick three winners for the 9 Club Mystery Box. We have stuff laying around here. We throw stuff in the box. Man.
It's et cetera box.
It's a big package.
Hey, there you
go. Oh, shit.
Nice big one.
I think mystery boxes are probably the best, like, because it's just a smorgasbord of literally cool stuff.
The best. Yeah.
Oh, Roger and I were here earlier just filling these boxes
up. It's the best.
So cool. Yeah. We were just like, dude, just kept filling them and filling them.
We got to get some like 9 club packing tape.
Oh,
yeah.
How do we do that?
I actually have a guy. We could do that.
You got to connect?
He's got a direct connect.
Between you and Kelly, with all the people you guys talk to, like, I'm surprised we don't have more shit here. That
we are doing shit too. You know what I mean?
Get us some 9 club packing tape.
Yeah, it'd be sick.
That would be tight.
Yeah.
You got that, Eldy.
Mm-hmm.
What would that look like? Would it be like black grip or black
It'd be cool if it was black and it just said fucking nine club.
Yeah, just over and over.
With this font. Boom.
Yeah, yeah, boom, 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 boom. Because then you could do like, just if you just did the like single, mm-hmm. or if it was just like the all, you have the choice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Be sick.
Boom.
Boom. Boom. Or I could just say boom. Boom.
Yeah, I was.
Boom. That sounds pretty.
Get a package, it just says boom.
I think it should say this.
Sal's for breakfast with some heirlooms. Boom. Or I could say that.
I could say that.
I'd love to see somebody try and translate that.
Like the backstage, salads for breakfast, boom.
Salads for breakfast. Salads for breakfast with some heirlooms, boom.
That'd be a good t-shirt too.
I think every packing tape should be different. Like we should have a
1,000.
1,000, 1,000, 1,000. We should have a
soft ass.
People at the post office are going to be like, okay, soft ass. What it is. Soft ass.
We all get one? Do we all get like one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Roger never goes limp. I fuck with eggs. I would like to have that
you
one.
Like that one? Yeah. You like that one?
Yeah. I fuck with eggs.
And then we could just have so one that's this.
It's like that big. It's like
a little packing tape.
So, you know, we talk on the Nine Club, you know, it's talk shows, all these things.
Definitely.
He talks, you know, and you know, we have certain discussions and we play clips and we talk about the clips and everything. And there was one clip last week that we had a big discussion about. Big discussion about. Mm-hmm. And it happened to be Lucas Puig had a commercial come out. Or he had a video part, right? In the end of the video, it was he did a line and the plane went by with the banner and everything. Dubs thought it was CGI no matter what. Nobody could change Dubs'
mind. First of
all,
I did not say it was CGI. I definitely said it might have been messed with a little bit. Okay. CGI is a whole different thing.
You said it was
CGI
fake. Yeah,
I didn't say it was fake.
Let's run the clip back.
Did I say it was
run the fucking clip back?
Okay, you know what? What else does that mean? Obviously, you're saying you thought it was fake.
I didn't think it was fake. I said they might have piece-maked it together type right. thing. Okay. So whether that... If I did say it was fake, look it. My budget ass regurgitates that back. You know what I mean? And I'll accept that. But come on, at the end of the day, it did look fucking fake.
Yeah. It did, because we broke it down. So it was like, you know, it was from far away. The line was coming in. There was no plane. And then all of a sudden this banner pops out. Like we were just dissecting it. Totally. You know, we were wondering where the plane was, right?
Dubs had us kind of tripping. Me and Steezes were
like, I kept that same energy. I knew that shit was real. I was giving my dog his props.
Yeah, I mean, I was there with you.
I was like, oh shit, it is. Like I literally thought it was real.
I brought it. Everybody started coming along with me. All right. But it's so crazy because looking in like the comments, I guess they were banging on all you guys. That didn't bring me up at all. So
this is the one thing that really. It chaps my hide, you know. It's like one of those. It's one of those ones that I'm like. Well, there's five people in the show, right? We all have different opinions.
Yeah.
We all have different opinions. And if Eldy says it's blue, right, and I say it's yellow, and then that person says it's blue, or no, wait,
what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's Eldy got me affected somehow. What I'm trying to say is that if Eldy says something. All the comments will be like, you guys don't know nothing.
Yes, yes.
You guys don't know this or that.
It groups everybody together.
I'm like, there's five of us.
Yeah.
There's five of us. We have five different opinions. Some of them are the same. Others are different, you know? And that's the thing I hate. It's like, don't group us together.
Remember the
If somebody says something, point that dude out. That's not me.
That's true. Remember the Moon Rocks thing where Roger said it was like, I forget what he said it was.
He said it was Molly.
Yeah. They're like, what the fuck?
These guys don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Yeah, these dudes are dumb. No.
When did that Moon Rocks? What?
But it back in the day,
okay.
it was Molly, but it has a new name now. People confirmed it. You know?
But they grouped us all and
they grouped us all
right that you right. all agreed and thought
and we
that
like
was
didn't
right.
even know we're yeah. like oh yeah I don't yeah. know
right. so myself I'm sure everybody here got all the DMs. Yasha from Adidas DM'd me and everybody was DMing and then Lucas posted it. He posted the clip of him
so fucking
trying
dope.
All the tricks with the plane and all the bales and supposedly I forget the exact number but it was like. They were only going to do 16 or 17 passes. Mm-hmm. And this was the last pass.
The one he got was the literal.
Got
yeah.
So good. Was the so last
fucking
one.
Dope.
Dude, the oh my god, the pressure of this is,
that was wasn't that the cat the yeah, catcher was just like yeah, pressure,
under pressure
under pressure yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, he must people are like, what are you tripping on? He's like,
ah, yeah,
like,
and I definitely was not trying to take yeah. anything away from him. Just like, no, let's be no, clear,
we were definitely. Having a debate,
yeah,
we were just having a fun day. That's what we do, that's what and friends I, do we sit we around like and we the, talk
we
about
like
shit.
These conversations exactly. At the end of the day, it's a conversation.
I love it.
No one's
but listen, going through his comments on his this post, even like Chima was like, oh dude, I thought that was CGI for sure. Yeah.
Like, thank you. We weren't thank
the
you,
only,
Chima.
Yeah, we weren't the only one.
I appreciate that.
Look at this place with the fucking dude, buildings right in the fucking mountain. I was like, beautiful. Showing my wife, I'm like, let's go there.
That's in Biarritz.
Yeah, Biarritz. Yeah. Yeah.
And I feel like the one he did, it couldn't have been timed any better. He landed and was able to look straight up, and there it was.
Because some of the other ones were a little off.
Yep.
Right? And he did it perfect.
Dude, that was so serendipitous.
Yeah.
As it should.
Because then, you pan up and there's the plane. This one, like, it takes a while for it to come. Right. But the one he did was, and I think they said in the post that they sent Roger, they tightened the loop a little bit for the last one.
Right.
Yeah.
There's probably, obviously.
He even showed like a map of it, didn't they?
Yeah.
I was like,
because they had to go around that fucking mountain that that Eldy just pointed out.
I mean, I can't even imagine that. That would have to be like somebody, I don't even know, maybe a kicker, you know, it's the game-winning fucking kick or like whatever the fuck it is for a skateboarder. Mm-hmm. That flowing through his body right there was like, yo, that would be crazy, dude. Yeah.
That was a game-winning three right
that
there.
That was the game that for fucking half LeBron, court. Like fucking just half court.
No, AD.
AD.
It's like a penalty. It's like a penalty kick almost. It's just you. No one else.
Yeah, exactly.
It's
yeah.
just
that's what
you.
I was thinking like more like a kick or something.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
It's pressure knowing that like you only have a certain amount of tries.
Right.
You can't stay there all day with the plane just circling.
Right. And then you also got to take into consideration the pedestrians.
Yeah.
Like if somebody throws you off on one of your lines, like then you got to go. It's not just you.
And you got to land the back tail every time.
Well, he's got like, that. You know, I think he's got the back tail.
The easy tricks. Yeah. Like, still, you think it in your head.
Yeah. It's got to look good. Like, there's so many factors that,
And plus, you want to do a good line.
Of course.
You don't want to do some budget line.
Right. You don't want him to have no budget.
Dude, I can't stop looking at the building in the rock.
Let's take a closer look.
It's so good. It's so good.
It looks so dope right there. Oh yeah,
it's just pretty sick.
Wow, it does look dope.
With this on the other side,
yeah,
it's like in the rock.
Yeah,
yeah.
Should we go there?
Let's go.
Are we allowed? I don't know if our passports will get us in.
No,
right
we're not allowed.
Shoot. You can go some places. You can't go.
Yeah, we got like 28 countries.
Yeah, we can't go there.
Well, let's see. I wanted to get to this one thing, but I think that Kelly would definitely appreciate this. Jesus, I don't really know his thoughts on it, but Jankum did the history of the skateboarder's favorite camera, the VX.
This was a good piece, dude.
It's Jankum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They do rad shit.
Yeah.
I wonder who did the voiceover on this. It was like, cool, all right. Like, professionals, fuck.
Those are the transfer tapes I remember.
Yeah. The
big
ones.
Big-ass transfer tapes.
Yeah.
Look at that. Imagine back then you get that box. You go to like the little camera store or whatever. You come home with that. You're fucking psyched.
Yeah, I remember my homie got that box. And we were so psyched.
Hyped, bro.
Changed everything.
I didn't realize it was so big in porn, too. That was insane to hear all that.
I know. Yeah.
San Fernando Valley.
I mean, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Legendary. That's where it all goes down.
That's where you're from, right?
Yeah.
Porn capital of the world.
The flag is there. That's where I stay.
Don't want to get on it too much, but the primitive warehouse is in an old porn station.
Oh, really?
It was. Yeah. Or is the one that current?
The current one is.
I think I did hear that.
Yeah.
That's fun.
That's fun.
Sips a beer.
Jankum, they just do rad stuff, you know. I love what they're doing, man. Ian Mishna and the whole team over there.
It was definitely interesting to see how when they had the camera, but then the fisheye came out and that changed it even more. I guess
That's
the best.
That's the best.
It's the best.
Oh wow, it is.
The dunk contest where Shaq pulls out the VX1000.
Like, just what is Shaq like doing with the VX1000 at a dunk contest, bro? Come on, man. Yeah. That dude don't need to film nothing.
Looking like a GoPro, like it's just so small. Like,
I might use that as my wallpaper.
I need the best camera at this moment. Let me get it. What is it? The VX? Okay.
But you know, he could have had somebody else sit there and film it for him. Like, sure. He doesn't need to have a little VX.
I wonder what that footage is.
Dude, that thing looks like an iPhone in his hand.
Yeah, it looks like GoPro. Like what he said, it's so tiny.
That thing is small. Yeah. That's such a great photo.
Yeah, so good.
But yeah, I mean, not only skating, just used throughout the world.
Yeah, it was interesting for them to break it down to where it was like, Huff, yeah, it was used.
there's a porn stuff.
So many different ways.
Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah.
San Fernando Valley.
No, just with the, what they were saying, like it was easier for like news on location to take those out. And if they got damaged, it wasn't a whole thing. Mm. You know?
Go check it out. It's a good watch. It's long. I was like, that's a good amount of time.
Very informative. Yeah. And like in skaters terms too. It's like done really well, but every skateboarder could listen to it. Like, oh yeah.
Yeah.
Go check it out. It's a good watch. Like I said before, all the links we talk about, all the videos are in the description below on our YouTube channel. So go check it out.
It was interesting when they said like a lot of people use it as like more of like a, what word did he use? Like a prop almost. Like there are certain skateboarders and filmers that love it and it reminds me of a certain time. Mm-hmm. And some people use it as like just like a,
trend. I remember that portion of it too. Yeah.
And I was like, it's pretty realistic. You know what I mean? Like they're like Brian Panabianco, like those, like in like the GX1000. That's like that's their life. That's what they love that camera, and they know they use it because that's what it takes them back to
it's
certain
a time machine.
Time. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and they love it. And then like there's certain people that
use it that don't necessarily know how to use it properly, like those dudes, and it just becomes a. Not a gimmick necessarily, but sort of just like you said, a prop of like, oh, I'm on trend because I'm using a VX, and that's where it kind of gets a little convoluted.
You can see like the authentic VX1000 users.
Yep.
And then you can see the people that like are just trying to be like skaterish almost in a weird way. But
remember when you bought yours, Kelly? You didn't use it?
Used it a couple, like twice, and then I realized I'm not a filmer. Like, I love it, but I didn't.
Tried it.
I didn't have the time to film. It. I like literally, I'm like, I can't go out and film all it. But I did, like, if someone wanted to use it, like, go ahead and use it. And Chris trying to put me down like that, bro.
I'm just saying, dude. You're like, there's the people who just buy it just because it's a V, and you that was.
Well, no, I wanted the intention. I have the same intentions that Brian and those dudes do. I love that camera.
I'm just giving you a hard time.
Yeah, but I'm trying to clarify this.
Clarify it, big dog.
It's okay, bro. We got you.
Yeah.
Where is it now?
Trevor Thompson has it. He does weekend stuff. And I was like, dude, I'm selling to the right person.
Well, no, because they took it here. They stole it from you.
Well, then I did.
Okay, Grant, they put it in the bag by accident.
Yensura accidentally put it into his box of stuff when he brought here. So he went home with him. And I had my lens. No, I had the lens. And then over like 2 years later, I'm like, hey, you just want to buy that thing off me? And he's like, oh, yeah, cool. And they bought it for $1,000.
Wow. Amazing. That sucks, man. When you've just been in possession of something for so long. Like, and then they're like, you want to buy it? And I'm like, I've had it for like a year. You want me to pay for it now?
They didn't use it, though. That was the crazy part. Dude.
That's how I felt today when I got a fucking parking ticket. I'm like, motherfucker, I already paid for this shit. Been here already. And I got a parking ticket.
Wait, because you're there too long?
I was there too long. Like, man.
That's a shame. Okay, easy guys. We got Logan's back. Logan is back.
Yes.
13 years old from Marietta, bro. Watch your language, LD.
Wait, am I on right now?
What's up, Logan?
What's up?
What's up,
Logan? Listen.
Okay.
We're pressed for time, but I wanted to take your call. I wanted to get some updates of what new tricks kids are doing out there.
Well, first, I just want to say thank you so much for answering again. And from last week, I think it's been a week or maybe two, have been like pretty rad. And it's like really enjoyable.
What do you mean?
I just want to say thank you so much for that. Just like, I showed my parents the episode and they were like super stoked.
I love that.
And so are my friends. And like it was just pretty awesome. Like looking back on it, it's pretty funny.
Amazing,
that's so cool, man.
Well, I'm psyched that we could, make you famous?
He asked a good question.
He did.
Logan, I look at the board here of all the people's questions that call in, and I'm like, this kid is 13. He's asking a great question.
Yes. I mean, I was just thinking about it for so long, and now that I've called already, I just kind of got my confidence of a call again. And I there hope this question is as good as the other one, but it might not be. But I don't know.
You're the best.
You got it.
What do you got? Okay. Your connection's so a little weird right now, but we'll deal with it. Go ahead.
Okay. So this question was, if there's one thing you can change about the skateboard industry, what would it be?
The pay scale.
How much time, yeah, I was going to say, how much time you got, little fella?
He must have asked some good questions, bro. That's a fuck.
Well, I just answered.
You might be stumping me, but yeah, that's
Chris
a
nailed it.
Chris definitely nailed it.
That's the pay scale. It's not be. I don't want to get into it, Logan.
So good.
There needs to be like a union. We need to have a skate union, dude.
Dude, so, fuck that. Dude, so
okay,
dude.
Real quick, Kelly, is there anything you'd like to change about the skateboard industry?
I mean, anything. The skate industry is just like this vast, like open universe that doesn't even like stop. I don't even know if that makes any sense, but
is there anything you'd like to change about the skateboard industry?
I'd say maybe the politics of it all. Just the whole, it's so many, trying to think of the best way to kind of articulate this. There's so many things that go into the skateboard industry that don't necessarily have to do with people's talents on a skateboard.
Sure.
And sometimes that could, it could make or break someone's potential to be a part of the skateboard industry because someone else who already has a power position in the industry feels some type of way about that person, about their something they've done in their life outside of skateboarding, whatever it may be. But I feel like these quote unquote gatekeepers can manipulate people's opportunity to make it in this industry.
And I feel like that rings true now, but still, but years ago.
Oh,
more
yeah.
mm-hmm. years ago, it was like there was a very
totally.
Strict like you more, in or you're
it was
in
more tight or? Tight netted in a sense of like weren't letting outsiders in, so to say.
Right.
I hate saying that, but like that's part of it. And
yeah
but it still happens now. Like
oh
if
no
you
it
see
does
somebody who is rocking with a brand or a company or something that doesn't necessarily have the cool factor within skateboarding, some people will then look to that as like, oh man, this person, I like, they kind of like brush them off. Even though their talents are exceptional, there's still a lot of that politics.
But it also comes to personality too.
Truly.
I agree with that.
Definitely.
Yeah. And what I think about when I say that is Kyle Berard. Remember when there was even moments where, you know, he was the contest dude or he was riding for X sponsors or whatever. And he was incredible on a skateboard, but I think that kind of hindered his growth within the industry. And you see that with a lot of dudes. Like, I don't want to name names, but
yeah,
you know,
no, totally.
Some people they'll be on certain board sponsors and they can't get a shoe sponsor because they ride for that board sponsor.
That's right.
You're like,
that's the politics. Like, we're talking
politics.
About.
Exactly. Yeah. That's how I wanted to articulate that.
Yeah. There's also goofs that can skateboard very well. You know what I mean? At the end of the day.
No, that's true. Yeah. You hit the tail on the donkey at the end of the day. There is a lot of personality. It speaks volume. If you can't interact and really, you know, fuck with people in a sense, that's going to be a telltale that's not going to work for you.
Yeah.
And that sucks, but at the end of the day, it's not just about skateboarding. Dude, it's a full pack. If you can have a full package, you're going somewhere.
Yeah. Totally. Sometimes
sorry, go ahead.
Oh, just because personality sometimes outshines the skating.
You're everybody can rap. I fucking freestyle with my homies. Cool. Nobody can do it like, you know, you got to have the whole package, man. At the end of the day.
There is not like a certain thing that you do that like you do this and you're pro. No. Like, you know what I mean? Like there's no like, you do these tricks and you're there. Like, it's hard to let people know, like kids know that. Mm-hmm. That's the hard thing for kids to understand probably too.
Yeah. I mean, Chocolate, like we've talked about this before a million times. Like we've saw people come through the gates or like whatever, just like we looking at people or them looking at people being like, why is this guy not on chocolate?
Yeah. Right.
Why is this guy not on da da da? But they have a thing because we're going on trips with these people.
Yeah.
We're you know.
But a lot of them, also a lot of them, because there's people like Carlos or Hibero and all these people that were on flow for chocolate. So it's both sides.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
It's you like, can, there's can, nothing wrong with Carlos. He was right. Awesome. Just no, it didn't work out.
Of course. Right. Of course.
But what about you, Dubs?
As far as?
Changing the industry, man. One thing.
I mean.
Pay raise.
Yeah, I mean you that is huge.
That's mine.
You can't like if your board's not selling, then you don't deserve to get a certain amount of money. You know what I mean? There has to be some sort of level of like where it makes sense for the business. So I get the aspect of what people are being paid, but sometimes you know. If you can try to step outside of the box, which business, you don't really get to do that sometimes, the numbers don't match up. So therefore, that's why we're in the place we are. So there's a handful of people that really get paid well based off board sales. And that's just the way it's going to be because they have a popularity. They have a following that, you know, lives up to that, so to say. Is there anything I want to change? You know what? It is what it is.
Yeah.
I'm not going to change nothing because I've had a great career in skateboarding and leading up to this point, and I enjoy every element. I can't speak down on it in that way for myself.
Sure.
Yeah. So
and listen, I joke about the pay raise thing. It's funny, but it's true. But it also, it's like, man, some of these. I get it. You know, it's NBA, this, that, big leagues selling out stadiums and merch and all this stuff. Like, skateboarding ain't there. Right. You know what I mean? Like they are only paying within their means.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah.
There should be, I wish there was a certain rate that everyone got.
I know.
Like there was some sort of
union. I could skate for the same company as you, doing the same exact stuff, getting the same ads, and we could have totally different checks.
Absolutely. Yeah, totally.
You know.
Yeah.
I can't front though. Girl in Chocolate was really holding that line for a long time where we would just have base minimum, you get paid, and they were nice. They were nice. I didn't know my boards weren't selling that. Mm-hmm. So I mean, whether it's on a monthly thing where you're killing it, and it was very steady for me, so I didn't have to go just live off board sales. Right. It was like, you know, I was very thankful for what they were providing at that time.
What about you, Logan, 13-year-old from Marietta? What would you change about the skateboard industry?
I have no idea. I mean, I'm not interested. I mean, if I were to change anything about the culture or something around those terms, I'd probably just be being more open-minded.
Dude, this guy.
And being more accepting of others.
I love you.
Is someone telling you to say this?
So rad, Logan.
I told you, we're getting played.
13. He's 13, right?
Not 13. I don't believe him.
Yeah.
I think he's like 35, and he has a little voice.
Yeah, he's like talking to a little voice thing.
I got it's him. Actually Roger.
Yeah, Roger's back there.
Yeah, Roger.
What would you guys change about skating industry?
That was rad.
Amazing. All right, Logan, listen, man, we got to go, bro. And you want to shout out anybody before you go?
The Nine Club.
Give your homies some shout out, dude. Give your homies some love, bro.
Okay, the my friends. Okay, yeah. I feel like we're doing that, but okay. All
right. Yes.
Adam, my parents, Connor, Kian, Crob, Kelly, Jerome, Raj, Steezus, Eldy.
I love it, man. He just won an award. He's giving a speech right now. I love it, bro. Logan, you're the best, dude. Call back anytime, and keep thinking of these great questions, man.
Yeah, you're already on
your
roll.
Thank you so much. Wait, can I? All right, thank you so much.
Can you what?
Oh no, I forgot what I was gonna say.
Okay. All right, Logan, man. Have a good night.
You're the man, Logan.
All right, you too. Thank you so much.
Later, brother.
Later, buddy.
Later, Doc. So rad.
Wow. Bye. What a good kid.
Bye. He's a good kid.
Great kid.
I don't believe he's 13, though. God. I think he has a voice modulator. He's 47 years old in the basement.
That was sick, too. We got heavy on this shit, and he's just like, I hear his little thing.
Yeah.
His little, yeah. Duffy's like in the back.
So good, dude.
That's a great question, too.
That's a great question.
That would have been a better question, I think, 10 years ago or something, when there was the definite skate industry. Does that make sense? Now it's like there's YouTubers and all these things.
Yeah,
that are
yeah, it's a little more, it's a little more open. But yeah.
Plus,
yeah,
when you're on the spot, it's hard to kind of think like when you really fully think about what you want to say. Right. Like we can come up with some shit, but at the end of the day, this is just like
skateboard.
Well, that's, well, that's the best part about it, I think, because then it's like top of mind. Whatever the first thing, it's like
totally.
I think it's a double-edged sword, right? Because there's people. You know, we get hit with these questions and we got to answer them right away. Mount Rushmore, this or that. And then people in the comments are like, well, you guys didn't. I'm like, you motherfucker, you probably had like 30 minutes to think about it and write your shit down.
Exactly.
Like we're just, we're off the cuff
spur
here.
Of the moment here, guys.
Like, just sitting there like listening to it. Then while you're listening to the rest of the show, typing in your Mount or whatever it is.
But
like,
here I am, the teacher calling on fucking Kelly to answer the, he couldn't even answer.
Right.
It's tough.
No, but it's a double-edged sword, right? It's kind of really dope. Like right off the top, but then it's kind of like, oh god.
But that's I think that's the real, like that's why this show is so important, because it's real. We're not sitting here with outlines. We don't get questions beforehand so we can formulate these PC responses. Shit is real. We have a conversation, we discuss, things might get heated, things, people might have differences, but that's why this is so important. That's what's supposed to happen.
Hey, and we're five people with five different minds, five different opinions. You know, sometimes they align, sometimes they don't. It's fine. Yeah. Sometimes people think the plane is fake, sometimes you know what I mean?
We're on the moon.
We're not on the moon.
Dubs.
I pushed it the hardest, so I have to feel it. So. On our little text feed, I showed that myself. I knew I was in the wrong. Okay, guys. Thank you.
All right. Here we go. Here we go.
LD's
All right. We are back.
Exclusive shit. Such a good one, dude.
For real.
This is like a piece of history right here.
Uh-huh. Right there.
I like that.
Pretty insane.
Like, you may have heard the name, but maybe never listened to his music.
That shit's ill.
I already. Can I guess who that was?
You could guess, but you won't get it right.
No, it's not DJ T Cuts.
Nope.
Damn.
Nope. That was Haku Skateboarding. Haku Skating.
Oh, that dude's the man.
How do you know?
His Instagram.
Oh yeah.
I swear, I seen three posts, and it's like Mark, Guy, and Eric. I think it was his first posts. But then he started, obviously that was his first, you know, post, and then he's been killing it, bro. Okay. Now I didn't know he made beats like that. Yo, I'm gonna have, straight up, I'm gonna have to give that one a high 8.
Okay. That's like a high 8.
What is that though exactly?
That's gonna be an 8.
What?
Yeah.
A high 8?
Yeah, that's an 8. That's an 8.
So it's not a high 8, it's just an 8.
It's just an 8.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I like it a lot. It's an 8.
Okay.
I had like
eight's good.
Totally. Yeah, listen, totally.
Eight's good.
I kind of got a weird trance at the end. I was kind of like, I kind of got lost.
And plus, Eldy was like,
I agree with you, Kevin.
Like, we were all in it and everything. It was one of those ones you like.
That's an 8.
Okay.
And that's a great score.
Yeah. Haku.
That is a fucking great score. The other one could have been an 8. You know what I'm talking about? Started off on an 8.
Yeah.
Haku. Lost it. Haku Skating. Thank you so much for that.
Bro, that was a really good one.
Okay, Eldy. We got that one. Eldy's pick of the week. And let's break this down, man. Who is it? We got Huff at the Sand Gaps.
Can we talk about the fact that this is a no-push line at the beach?
Yes.
That's crazy to skate it like that, dude. To skate those two back-to-back, those things weren't small in general.
No.
And they're close together.
And
to
start close. Over the...
Yeah, start that ollie. Come on.
Yeah, you have to go full speed ollieing. That thing is tall.
Yeah.
I never ollie one of those things.
His shirt was moving, though, Steezes.
Told you. You catch it, man. Mm-hmm.
And the red shirt.
No.
Love it. Yeah. Love that.
I picked it, and obviously you guys did a great job of actually getting the right clip, but...
Mm-hmm.
Daniel Castillo, our homie,
yes,
was who I saw it from first. And then it's the Sand Gaps.
Yes.
And we talk about fucking shove it, kickflips. And, just a lot of things made sense. You know, everything made sense right yeah, here. Yeah. And, you know, and it just like that all for me was the ollie. That ollie over that thing, come to Santa Monica mm-hmm. and check one of them motherfucking things out. Yeah, the way yeah. he ollied that thing was.
Like he was ollieing up a curb.
So yeah. G. Mm-hmm. It was so fucking.
It was super comfortable.
It was a proper, like sucked up to his feet, never left his feet yeah. at all. Like
mm-hmm. it was just like, and you know how when sometimes when you ollie up high things, like you do a little bit of shimmy shake kind of thing.
To kind of make sure you get over it.
Mm-hmm. It didn't even mean nothing. Mm-mm.
True.
This That's was from crazy. His reel to reel part.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Slow that off.
Dude, like.
Oh my.
Dude, like, could have gone over
with room to grow.
Could have, yeah. Hey,
could have put a board up there sideways.
Yeah.
That would be awesome if you did that.
Right?
Dude, that right there was just, I was like, whoa.
Like, I've ollied those, but it you know, it wasn't like. Like I was tired afterwards. Yeah.
We're not doing like three tricks after.
No. Like I was like, whoo, I'm gonna go.
That was it.
I gotta go get some Gatorade.
And the expression on his face too is just so casual. Like this is what I do. It's not because you know some people like you can when you're trying something, it shows on your face.
Yeah. For sure.
Fuck, man. This one.
That's crazy, though, right? You would watch or look at old magazines or any magazine, really.
Bro.
You can see their face.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so funny how, like, some people, you're like, oh, God, they look crazy.
Dude, my last ad, real shit, I'm just side note. My last ad, when I went out with Blaybach, my face, look at my face at the last girl ad.
Bro, your shit was crazy.
Yeah. It was. I said that to Mike. I'm like, bro, I don't, my face. You know what I mean? Just because it looks like I'm trying like extra hard, which I was trying.
Yeah.
But it looks like my face looks crazy. So what? I think we should definitely show that.
Yeah, what?
And Eldy's just showing no remorse. Like,
I felt bad for Dubby. I was like, whoa.
Damn. You felt bad. Wow.
Damn.
But you know how
come wow. I know I'm just
bad. No, because Dubs. Hey, not for nothing, Malto has a horrible fucking.
I wanted to say it when you said that, but I was like, Malto, that's my boy. I can't throw him under the bus.
No, but he has a horrible fucking like in the moment face. Like it's
don't worry, Dubs. Like, we could turn off his mic.
For real, dude. Wow. No, but like what? for real. No, come on, bro. I like that. You come on. I already knew it, so I called myself out. So, but at the end of the day, I said that to Blaine, but Blaine said, like, dude, why are you worried about that? I'm like, it's not that I'm worried about it. It's like, I don't necessarily like it.
Yeah. It was like shot from like underneath, right? Like you could see, you were looking down.
Yeah, you could see my face expression. Right. Like I'm trying to get over this fucking thing.
I thought you looked great, Dubs. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
I thought you looked great too.
I know you did. Yeah. I gave you a high five.
I know.
You said he looked crazy.
He did look crazy. My boy looked crazy. I like to see my boys flourish
Believe it. I questioned him, so whatever. I'm sorry.
Hey, it happens.
You're skateboarding. On that.
You know what I'm saying?
We're trying out here. Shit.
But can I point something out real quick? Keith lands this kickflip shove it. He doesn't even move his front foot to back 180.
Oh, my God.
So good.
Doesn't even move his foot.
Dude, I remember looking at the spot and then going there when I was a kid and being like, holy fuck, they're mm-hmm. so close.
Right.
Yeah.
They're right next to each other. Like,
to do a double, it's not easy.
It's no.
not
easy at all.
Dude, the rotation of the half cap flip, when it dips down like that, that's
the proper nose dips.
The proper technique.
Mm-hmm. And then the half cap flip is just...
Ooh, yep. I love that trick.
That's
dude.
How it should look.
Yes, yeah. I love that That's trick so much.
If I buttery. Did one in my life that looked like that, I'd be content.
Yeah.
Because I had a shitty back half cap flip.
That ollie though.
I know.
Yeah.
Let's give watch that ollie. Let's give Keith a.
I'm glad it was this one.
Yeah.
I'm glad it was this one.
Look at that. Let's give Keith
I'm gonna feel super fucking honored in with everybody involved in this shit to have this go with this.
Yep.
Yeah. Hold on, sorry. Let's back this up real quick. Let's do this properly.
Yeah.
LD's
All right. We are back. Exclusive shit.
Such a good one, dude.
For real.
This is like a piece of history right here.
So good.
Rodgers right there.
Pretty insane.
Like, you may have heard the name, but maybe never exactly. listened to his music.
That shit was ill.
He's gone with the edit right there.
Wow, dude.
That was
dope.
Boom. That was dope.
Boom. I love it when you're like, that's a piece of, who said that? That's a piece of history right there.
Eldy.
That's right, man. Hey, shout out Keith Hufnagel, man.
Yeah, man.
Seriously. Fuck, I'm going to miss that guy a lot.
Hell yeah.
Big time, man.
A lot. All right, man. Good stuff, Eldy. Yeah. You do have an honorable mention. Do have an honorable mention.
Man, I had to honorable mention somebody.
Ryan Townley.
Oh, wow.
That's pretty sick, right?
Yeah, that yeah. is.
That was super dope. I've never seen that.
Yeah, how did he think of doing that? What right? the hell?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Skid. He's got rails on his board, too. I don't know if that matters at all, but
it just doesn't yeah. whatsoever.
Yeah. But it is. I always trip out when I see people when they're out skating street spots.
With rails?
Like, but like skating tables, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I would have rolled up to that spot and been like, oh man, somebody is just messing around. I got to take this down. This is somebody, somebody is fucking fucking with us, man. I got to take this down.
I want to see, how did you see?
I was guy, just going to say that.
Yeah, how do you see he's got rails on the board on his board?
You see it when he lands right there.
Right where?
It looks thicker right there.
He's right. Dude. No, he's right.
I think he does ride rails.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
But can you see it?
That was cool.
Yeah, when he lands,
you can't limit yourself if you have rails on. If he felt that day and he had his rail board on, go for it.
Oh no, I just noticed that stuff.
That's rail for sure.
Okay.
Look how thick that is.
Yeah, that's for sure.
That's for sure rail.
Damn, crazy.
But I always trip. Know how funny it would be to be like a janitor or whatever at the school and you come back to school the next day. Oh, we talked
about
day.
That with the Daywan shit. Right.
Yeah, you're like, yeah. what the
Well, I'd hope that he'd take it down.
That's what I was for. If you don't want to burn the spot,
right.
you
right.
take the
people
shit down.
People did do that. They'd
for
let,
sure.
People were like, oh, I don't care.
Those are the guys that don't
yeah.
care don't, at
yeah,
all.
Yeah. Totally.
We're going to save this the best for last. Man. Not the best.
Wait.
Not the best.
Wait.
What?
I did start an Instagram for Eldy's pick of the week.
Okay.
I post once a week the Eldy's pick of the week.
Okay.
So if you want to follow it, I mash up.
What's the handle?
Eldy's pick of the week. Yes. Perfect. So if you want to follow it, you get one post a week and it's the mash of the pick with the song.
With the song.
So awesome. This yeah. one's going to be the second one. Jordan
Morning
was the first one.
Okay.
And this one will be the second one. Mm. But this, yeah.
Well, I'll follow that up with saying that thank you so much to Haku Skating for that song. And if you want to send us a song, send it to pickoftheweek@thenineclub.com. Copyright free. It's got to be your own music. And just send a little MP3 or a WAV file. You know, no Google Drive thing, Dropbox, none of that. Just a little and maybe like 15 seconds. You know, 15, 30 seconds max, maybe.
Yeah. That was a pretty long one.
It was a long. Yeah, it was good. It was good.
It was,
yeah, good.
But it was worth it.
It was good. That's what I'm saying. If it's 30 seconds, perfect. And I'm like, God, we're gonna. It's not that. I don't know. Right? It's got to be good if it's 30
it's
seconds.
Got to be good.
Yeah. I thought this was interesting. We were talking about this last week, and they will double back around to it because you know this pro gamer stuff. You know, we have our channel, Two Dudes, One Game. And we play video games on there, myself, Steezus, and Mike Mo. And this was amazing watch, dude, because these motherfuckers make a lot of money.
So I didn't watch the video. Could you guys give me an update of what this was about?
It was on the list, bro.
I didn't. I'm sorry.
It was actually really interesting.
Yeah.
Really interesting.
Eldy's looking like he didn't watch it either.
I watched probably the first 5 minutes of it.
Tell us what's going on in this piece.
Basically, Chris broke it down. It's a show that Complex does called Jobs Unlisted, and it just happened to be the episode where he was going and speaking to different professional gamers or people that are streamers or things of that nature. And it just kind of broke down, like, this kid specifically, I don't remember exactly what the amount was, but within a 3-hour period, he won
like 1.2 million.
Something like that for a Fortnite tournament.
Crazy.
So then it just kind of goes into, you know, talking to different people from FaZe Clan, talking to our boy Avalanche at 100 Thieves as well. Like, just really breaking it down of what it means to be a streamer or a professional esports athlete and sort of how the things break down, whether it be through competition earnings or through salary from your organizations. Mm-hmm. And it's the reason I thought it was dope to put it on the list is because the parallels from the gaming industry to the skateboarding industry are they're right neck and neck, you know?
Yeah, totally.
Because these people want to be on organizations, which is the same as getting sponsored for a board brand. Yep. And then finding different ways to make money, whether it be through contests or through your own content. Hmm. So to equate it to video parts or stream, you know, things like that. So it's the norms of what it means to make it within these industries are so neck and neck that I thought it was really cool to kind of share that.
It's fucking awesome.
Is it kind of similar in the skate industry, the way you come up as a skateboarder? Like in this world,
like you could get discovered by if you're live streaming, and that the one dude got mm-hmm. discovered for just posting his little videos.
Yes.
And the guy hit him up and was like, "Yo, I want you to join FaZe Clan or whatever."
Yeah, this dude Swag, like, who's been streaming and doing content on YouTube for a very long time. He's one of the top Warzone streamers right now, and FaZe Apex, who's one of the guys that started FaZe Clan back when it was like a sniper clan, took notice of that, and he was watching his streams because he wanted to get better at the game himself. So it's similar to our conversation last week of mm-hmm. like, yeah, I want to watch these guys because then I can become better at something I enjoy doing,
right.
And then that led to him being a part of the organization, and now they got a $30 million house in over here in on the west side.
It's crazy. Like, well, no, the dude won 1.2. He's 19 years old.
Yeah. How many people are in on these teams, so to say?
It depends, because there's when you think of take it to like this. The organization, I'll use 100 Thieves for example. They have their content team, which is the YouTubers, the streamers, the guys that aren't necessarily professional. And then they have a professional CSGO. So Counter-Strike, they have their own team, which is 4 to 5 people. Mm. Then they'll have a team for, let's say, Valorant. And that kind of how it happens throughout a lot of it. Now, Call of Duty just changed to where they've created their own league. So now they have cities for each team. So last year they had 5-man teams. This going into 2021 season, they're switching to 4-man teams. But it's like you've got a team for Dallas, you've got a team for LA, mm. you've got a team for Chicago. Like,
what?
So it's all like it's turning into what the NBA is essentially.
Well, mm-hmm. even the NBA, there's the guys who play NBA 2K that are sponsored by
the actual teams.
The teams.
This guy, Lakers, like by like really?
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
And they have a whole league. Like these kids at the if you watch the video, Eldridge, the guys at the end were sponsored by the Brooklyn Nets.
No.
And they were in the facility with their video game setups and everything. Like, it was insane.
There's so many layers to this shit.
Layers.
Like, and they're just like, how they're just playing each other? Like, how the team, so they're just like, cool.
Yeah, it's just like if you were to watch the fucking Lakers versus the Nuggets.
Yeah.
So it's like, 5 dudes playing 5 dudes, mm-hmm. and then whoever last one surviving or the most point. I don't know.
Yeah, if you're playing NBA 2K, then it's like whoever. It's like
I'm sorry. I'm like obviously that, but I'm saying for like the other games.
Yeah. So for example, like Call of Duty, it'll be best of 5. So then they'll have there's certain maps or levels, whatever you want to call it, that are within the CDL, the Call of Duty League, and then they have certain game types, whether that be search and destroy, hardpoint, domination. So you'll play those throughout, and whatever team you know. Gets to 3 first, basically 3 out of 5. They move on to the next, you know,
what
next team, things like that.
It's insane. It's a whole world, man.
It's a whole world that is just bubbling, but there's so much money being funneled into it.
Totally.
Because you look at dudes like Drake, he's a part owner of 100 Thieves. Post Malone just became a part owner of Dallas Empire, NRG, actually.
Wow.
So it's all these people, Scooter Braun, like there's people that are big within their industries that are now putting money. Rick Fox, he used to be an owner of Echo Fox. Like there's so many people that are tapping into this. Like I said, average salary pro gamer, 60K to 7 million. There's like, there's levels
that's
to this
psycho shit.
And you don't have to be, all right, there's fucking 13, 14, 15 year old kids that are making more money than I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Was it Ninja? Like he's a big.
Yeah, right. he was one that, I mean, obviously he's still very, very well respected, but he was one that sort of broke barriers and kind of crossed this whole like threshold of gaming just being like some shit you do in your parents' basement. He's been on the cover at ESPN, and like there are a lot of things that sort of funneled into the whole Twitch streaming thing that made that actually more accepted. And
fuck it, I'm getting legend into video games.
I'm trying to get into video games, dude. Playing two dudes and all this talk and stuff. And last week we were talking about my Twitch stream and all that. Well, I signed up for Twitch, bro.
There nice. You go.
Yeah. But the thing that really got at me though was like I'm sitting there. You know, you got to choose a username. You said mm-hmm. Okay, username whatever, and it said in the bottom there, you could change it after you make it. You know, to sign up, mm-hmm. you got to change your username. So I said, okay, Crob was taken. You know, Chris Roberts taken. All the usual suspects was taken. So I put in Crobby Crob. And
accepted.
It accepted Crobby Crob, but then I go in and it's like I can't change it for 2 months.
That's a good one. I like Crobby Crob.
Yeah, Crobby Crob.
I'm actually surprised you didn't do Chicken Knuckles.
Oh, that was my old gamer. Damn. But that was my old self. You know, I'm Crob.
He's reinventing.
Crobby, yeah. You didn't try right. Crobberts?
Crobby.
I tried a lot of them, dude. They were all taken, dude.
But see, that's the beautiful part about gaming. So, like, people call me Steezus, whatever. Obviously, that's not my fucking government name. But, like, within gaming, everybody has an alias.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's the best, like... So for you to be Chicken Nuggles within the gaming world, it's not strange.
Right.
You
know? Sure. And that's why I was like, oh, I want to just be Crob. And then was taken. Mm. And then I'm like, oh, I can change it when I get in there. Okay, cool. So I said Crobby underscore Crob. And it was like, cool, I got it. And it was like 2 months I got to wait. So now I'm stuck with Crobby Crob for 2 months.
I love that.
God, how embarrassing.
I love it.
I'm calling you Crobby Crob.
Crobby Crob.
I like Crobby, though. Just Crobby?
Crobby? Crobby? Crobby Crob. Anyway, I don't know. I mean, it's not like I'm a streamer, but I wanted to get into it. I thought it was fun. And Mike Mo does it. I'm talking to Mike Mo, and we do the two dudes. And I was like, dude, this could be fun, dude. Like, because I love Dr. Disrespect, you know. Not that I'm going to do Dr. Disrespect shit. He's on a...
He's been doing this for over a decade.
But you could chat in there. You could do whatever you want, you know. You could do...
Are you going to start, like, following streamers and kind of paying attention? Or how do you...
I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm... Listen, the only person I'm following is Dr. Disrespect. Because I just think he's on a whole different level.
Yeah.
And he's just pure entertainment. Like, he's got his whole...
He caters to your...
Was he shitting on you as he's beating you type shit?
Totally.
Yeah.
He's, like, shitting on you as he's beating you?
He has a whole... Dude, I'll send you a link.
Okay.
I'll put a link in the description, too.
This is new.
Bro, he's got green screens. He's talking to people off camera that aren't even there. Like, he's fucking, like... He's got his whole, like, glasses and he's got a wig and everything.
He's a full character.
But his graphics, like, he'll be like, all right, let's go to the arena. And he'll, like, go out. Then all of a sudden, he's standing in front of this arena. He's like, we got 70 million people in the arena right now. Let's go. Like, and he goes,
what?
That's amazing.
Two-time champ.
It's pretty funny. Wow. It's pretty funny. But
the gaming space, man, it's...
That's the guy that's getting like 15 million a fucking year.
Oh, he makes a lot.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, and that's the thing, too, with a lot of... The streamers, for example, like those dudes, it was kind of fun. Like you said last time, like people were like, I'm going to sit here and watch you play video games and give you money.
Right.
Yeah.
But that, like, that culture in the minds of the viewers and audience and the kids, that's not strange.
Right.
And the way I try and like break it down for people to understand is like you going to a bar and having a conversation with your bartender, you want to tip the bartender if you have a great conversation or if they're entertaining or they're taking care of you. Mm-hmm. So I think when you kind of put it into that mindset of you're not giving donations, you're giving tips. Yeah. It's pretty cool. And then sometimes people will, it's incentivized if you, you know, donate, then you can have your question read on stream.
Yep.
People want to feel acknowledged and they want to feel like, you know, my favorite professional gamer paid attention to me.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, it's like if you were watching the Michael Jordan back in the day and he was at halftime being like, oh, shout out Crobby Crob. And man, I'd be like, what?
Yeah.
Michael Jordan shouted Crobby Crob out.
Yep.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
I love that you have that conversation with someone. You're like, oh yeah, what's your username? You're like, Crobby Crob.
Crobby underscore Crob.
Yeah.
Crobby Crob.
I love it.
I wanted to change it as soon because I couldn't think of when I was just signing up.
Crobby Crob.
Oh, I'm not Crob, waiting to sign up. I'm signing up now.
I might just keep it. I might keep it.
I think you should keep it.
For
Chicken
sure.
Knuckles is good. I don't know, man. This is the problem I have with usernames. I don't know. I don't know what to do.
Keep it.
Yeah.
Anyway, who knows? I suck at video games anyway. I shouldn't say that. I suck at some video games.
There you go.
But dude, the thing, I mean, we kind of talked about it last time, as long as you're entertaining, like Tim the Tatman, who's a huge streamer on Twitch, made a whole viral moment out of not being able to win at Fall Guys.
I remember, yeah.
Oh, whoa.
And they, like, the developers got behind him and it became this big thing. Like, there was a full-blown sponsored stream to watch Tim try and win at Fall Guys.
Wow.
Because he's that bad.
Did he ever win?
He won his first game on stream.
Okay. Yeah. And that's when Fall Guys, I don't even hear about that anymore.
No, Among Us, like I said last week, Among Us kind of took the steam away from Fall Guys. And it's funny because you sort of watch
the game shit. Dude, right?
Like, this is a whole different language.
Yeah.
It's like listening to a skateboarder.
That's how the girlfriends feel when they hear us talk about skate.
Kelly's like. He's mind blown over there. He's like smoke's coming out of his ears.
Yeah. It's insane. Yeah. It's crazy though, because you'll see what games are popular because of what big streamers are playing them at that time.
Right.
And it just, that's where the energy goes. And, you know, Among Us, I think, had been out for 2 years. It was doing, you know, maybe 2,000 like viewers a week. And now they're like 240 something thousand viewers at one time.
Crazy.
It's funny. It's an interesting topic, and it does kind of parallel like the skate world with like contests and, you know, filling up arenas to watch Nyjah skate or these people and play video games and the FaZe clans and getting sponsored and it's a whole thing.
Yeah, the personalities in the company, just like Girl Chocolate, like they're, you know, people rock with the brand, and whoever comes on to be a part of the company, people accept them with open arms, because I'm a diehard Girl Chocolate Krell Tap fan.
Yeah.
And that's how it is with these organizations as well.
What's like the Girl Chocolate of the gaming
phase?
I thought it was phase, because in the piece they were like, they're the dopest dudes. They dress the freshest. Mm-hmm. Like
I mean, they're the ones that are doing, they'll do like collaborations with Kappa or Champion or Lovesack. Like they've transcended. Yeah, they've transcended just the gaming space. And now like Offset, Bronny, like they have so many people that are a part of phase that aren't necessarily just gamers. It's way beyond that.
That's amazing.
And there was another company, Optic Gaming, but they've gone through some like buyouts and some things. So it's changed a bit, especially with the Call of Duty space changing the landscape. But FaZe for sure is the one that I'm sure you've seen the logo and haven't even like known what you were looking
at. Right, yeah. Right. I'm sure that definitely
it's an interesting world, man. Yeah. It's an interesting world.
I love
world.
It. It's cool, man.
Krabby Krab's about to take over, bro.
I want to play video games again. I just don't know what to play. I want to play the old stuff I grew up playing, you know?
Yeah. The new shit is like so fucking next level.
I get nervous about, because I used to just sit there and just play all day. Like, I don't want to do that anymore.
K-Fatty is going to make a run for it. Going to make a comeback.
I think it's good to have, like, for me, like the homies back in Kansas City and like now throughout, you know, we're all living in different places, but that's how we stay in communication with each other.
Oh, okay.
Like, we'll get on the headset and, like, we're not talking shit to the fucking little kids that we're playing against. We're talking shit to each other. We're in a little party or whatever. And it doesn't consume our whole day. Like, we all have a real job, but we're still able to, like, all right, 7 p.m. our time, which is 9 Midwest and 10 East Coast. Like, we can all hop on and play a few games of Warzone and get on and talk shit. Or what we've been doing lately is, like, custom games. So we'll get together and we'll just, it'll just be us, like, six people in a room just, like, shitting on each other. And it's just the most fun because it takes us back to when we were kids when we could do that. But, you know, now we're all adults. Most of the homies have kids and shit. And it's just a way to stay in contact with the boys instead of like having to text or hop on the phone all the time. You know,
reconnect.
It's so funny, dude. Like, it reminds me of how I talk to people about golf. Mm. Like, I literally tell them, like, hey, if you watch it, this guy's making $1 million putt right here, or like whatever the fucking case may be. Yeah. Like, this is worth this much money for this, whatever. But what you're saying too is the same fucking thing. It's like just a bunch of boys going out there fucking bullshitting. Yep. Like, we all got our thing, we're gonna do it, but you're in front of a screen and we're on a course. Totally. But it's the same fucking thing.
Like, Friday night is our boys' night. Like, we like, where we dropping, boys? Like, that's the text we'll send. And like, we all know, like, all right, get your booze, get your snacks or whatever. Like, we're putting in some, you know. And it's the boys. Like, it's not just video games. It's like, we can't be together in a room like we are.
Right.
So it's how we connect and how we have a good time. And, you know, obviously we're all different time zones, different phases in life. But like, it's just a way to stay connected with your homies. And it's something that allows us to be kids again.
For a
short period of time.
It's fun.
Yeah, we're just having fun with each other.
Right? You focus any controllers?
Dude, I focus so many controllers.
Throw that bitch.
Like, bro.
Fuck.
I started focusing controllers back in like Halo, like Xbox 360 days. Like,
yeah.
I went through, bro, I used to have. Oof.
Oh, that reminds me. I just busted out my fucking Xbox I had like on the low that just has every video game.
Oh, you had one of the modded joints?
Yeah, like little. I just busted up because I wanted to like entertain, like showing Legend, like, hey, I got some video games, you know, but I haven't got there yet. And my wife's just like, no, not yet. Okay.
Right. Bro, I got a homie, like, I know we won't stay on this too long, but I got a homie whose little kids have been like watching. So when they lived in Kansas City and I was there for a while, they would like ask children, watch us play. And you know, like you give them the controller that doesn't have batteries or whatever and like let them think they're doing something. But then he sent me a video of his oldest boy playing one of the games we used to play and he's fucking good.
Oh, wow.
And I'm just like, oh shit. Like you think... you don't think that they're picking up on anything when they're kids, when they're watching it.
Yeah.
But it's like seeing him like with the controller and the headset talking to his teammates. Right. Like, I'm just like, oh shit. Like we got a little esports athlete on our hand. Like we going to the big leagues, man.
Stay on that track.
Yeah. I love it, man. Watch out, FaZe Clan. I'm coming.
Hey, FaZe Crobby Crob.
FaZe Crob. Well, let's switch directions here. Dude. Do we even need to say anything about this dude?
Gosh, dude.
Chris Colbourn.
Fucking insane, dude.
Dude's like just like a smart dude on a skateboard. Like, you know, you're like, how do you know how to use your skateboard
that
like
box? He's outside the box.
Yeah.
Dude, he's just talented, bro.
Yeah, opening clip was this. I was like, are you kidding me?
He didn't even break a sweat in that gray t-shirt either. You know that gray t-shirt will show some sweat
Chris, you already know, dude.
Whoa.
Yeah, I get nervous when I get a gray shirt to go skate. I'm like, nope.
You're like, wow, this is going to be bad.
I grinded it ill, too.
Yeah.
Dude, come on.
This was some different... His other parts were awesome. They're always super good. This is some, like, different shit, dude.
Yeah.
Dude.
Like, I would have been good with that.
He snapped out of it hella good.
I mean, like, you got that?
No joke.
He's got a beard going.
A nice little quarantine.
That's like
beard.
That's a Crob beard.
A little bit.
Yeah. Kind
of unkept.
Unkept and flesh tone.
That was a dope ass line.
He got the ill I would never do shoelace going on too here the way he
It's hella long.
Just tight as
Rambo shit right there.
Fucking,
this line was incredible.
Dude, that's COVID surfing. Spot, right?
Dude, you don't get attempts there.
He pimped that shit though.
You get kicked out in like 3 seconds.
Dude, he pimped both of
that's
those.
COVID.
All of it.
Where is this?
Yeah, he did.
It's in Orange County.
He did.
Wow.
To end it with that?
Literally.
It was just
damn. Look at the first kick. Look at this shit right here.
It's like a watch song.
Smooth as fuck.
That's to the Huff thing, like just into it.
Bro.
Yeah, that was really, really, really good.
Wait a minute. Did he push?
Nope.
He did not.
He started off surfing, swinging and banging, and then just came with it.
Look at that.
He didn't even
He didn't even flip that thing. It was like an ollie. It was like a fucking ollie.
That was a beautiful front three, too.
Look at the push.
What?
Yeah, and then took that transition, genius. Pushed off that transition.
What a crazy dude.
That was fucking sick.
Look at that.
Amazing.
Yeah, he's surfing right there.
You had to touch that bench.
Yeah, that's... So cool. This is... Dude, the control? Come on, bro.
How sick, dude.
Are you kidding me?
Like, manual front board would have been enough.
Yeah.
More than enough. What? Cookie dough. That's
so rad.
Crazy.
God, if I... That talent, man. Sky would be the limit.
Ooh.
Well, he's got the beard. You got the beard going for you. You can get that.
I mean, he could maybe, maybe I can get him to film. But he's goofy.
Just look how that looks. Fucked up trying that.
Oh, and you know that was just in between them setting up man ramp.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because that's the same Home Depot shit where they were doing that.
Yeah. Let me just do this real quick.
What? You can get
smoked.
Yeah, sir. Smoked.
Way worse than like getting that. It's a hippie jump. Fuck that. It's nuts. And he's got a gray shirt on too. He's not even. Is he sweating?
Mm-mm. A little bit.
Is that a shadow? Is that a shadow?
Oh, it might be a beard
That's
shadow.
That's a shadow. That's a beard shadow.
He's not even showing sweat on a gray shirt, dude.
Again.
Again? Are you shitting
That's
me?
That's why he wears gray shirts.
Just to show you that. Like, yo,
this is first try. Like,
just to show people.
I do this.
Oh, this is.
Oh my God.
Beautiful.
Wow, let me just shove it out. Fuck it for shits and giggles.
Feeble to back lip.
Pole jam feeble to back lip.
Pole jam feeble back lip. Yeah.
That's scary.
Shove. Yeah.
He got more speed coming out of that. Do you see how fast he's going when he came out?
Yeah.
God, he's incredible. A genius, dude. Oh, it's like him and like Mark Suchu or like on some other planet.
Some Jedi shit.
Yeah.
Imagine them sharing a part.
Oh, my gosh. Dude.
Mind blowing.
That would be sick. Could we get like a bunch, like a genius video part or a video where it's just genius. Like, it's just like the smartest dudes on a skateboard.
Mark funny. Johnson would be in there too.
Mark Johnson.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. Yeah.
Look at that dog. It's cute.
Big chilling.
That was a cute little setup.
That was a sick fucking line, man.
Hell yeah. Where that's in like that's in LA somewhere, right? I've never I've seen some people it skate it, but
I've never been there.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen a lot of people skating that shit, right?
Yeah, like Paul skated there back in the day.
Is that Barra the, that's not the stuff? One that goes into the bank?
This I don't know if that is. That looks like the same spot,
kind
though,
of
right?
Looks right. Yeah,
it's like a five stair. And then
is that Torrance? I think that might have been.
I almost feel like it's always filmed from like above or something. It's always filmed from like the where the dog is.
Or that, or there. I see a lot of lions fisheye.
Okay.
Yeah, because Barra did like half cat flip, then backside flip.
Oh yeah.
Oh, it's that spot.
Yeah. Paul did switch backside flip and then front heel.
Yep.
Okay.
Wow. Yeah.
It's in L.A. Roger comes
there
through.
He actually did break a sweat there though.
Oh, wait. Is he a gray shirt?
Yeah, I broke a sweat.
Oh, a little.
Oh, this is the one.
Broke a lot of sweats.
Finally. Jesus.
Finally, something was hard for you,
yeah,
Cookie.
Jeez. Come on, man. Well, and stop wearing gray shirts, dude. No. How many gray shirts you rocking?
That's
dog?
Tight. That's though, like a dude. Blue. Yeah, it's like his little go-to.
I'm just playing. That is
he's
tight.
Producing.
Yeah. Not looks that hard.
Huh? Yeah, it's a little baby blue.
Little baby
yeah,
blue.
It's a baby blue.
Yeah.
That rail is so fucking.
Get your
fun.
Shirt colors right, Kelly.
I followed your lead though, right there, Kelly.
Dress black and blue or white and gold,
dude.
And that trick was insane.
Yeah, that trick is
like the shirt's cool, but the trick was not really dope.
No doubt.
That's does like, that trick have a name?
Fucked.
Cookie? Like, cookie. What? Look at that.
Because you don't.
Does Chris Cole do that one or no?
He does the other way.
The other way.
Oh, like,
the other
way. So it's back 180 to switch feeble.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right? Chris Cole does front 180 to switch feeble, and he usually brings it back.
Right.
Front yes, switch. Yes. Yeah.
That was fucking dope.
That was dope.
Yeah.
Was
I think insane. Like.
I would almost like to see him come out at 180.
Yeah, that'd be
all the way around.
All the way around. Wow. Wow.
Wait, is that the same one? It is the same trick, but
the other one's alley oop. So it's like
yeah, you're right. So yeah. It's not the same.
It's not
thing.
The same. Okay. Yeah. Because this it would take if he was doing it like, the opposite way, it would be.
It would be fucked. First off,
yeah.
I'm just trying to think. Though I don't understand. I
can't even picture myself doing it.
Yeah, I don't
I know.
But this one almost is like, why isn't anybody doing that? That seems
it
like
a, it would be like really it tough. Would be like to switch feeble and you but come the, out 180.
No, it would be
no back 180.
Back 180 switch yes. Front feeble. What, is that,
yes, okay, exactly.
Yeah, if yep. You were to do it the Chris Cole yeah. Way, mm. This
makes
is
sense. I feel like.
I mean, because yeah, cool, it's like, actually though that's a pretty. I mean, obviously it's an incredible trick. Imagine the other way, front 180 to switch front feeble.
Yeah.
That would be no one's. I don't see anyone do that.
Nope.
All right, Kelly. What color shirts are you wearing in the next clip?
Gray.
Mm-hmm, let's see. White.
Oh, but
and it's a ringer.
It's a ringer.
Mm. Wow.
Are you kidding me, dude?
That's what's that? That's at that spot. That's yeah.
That's a sick spot. Yep.
He caught that back 180 and then literally
the momentum was beautiful.
Yeah, he caught backside flip and then kept swinging it.
Look at that. He turned halfway down. Mm-hmm. Look, right there, he's still facing us.
He is.
Yeah, we turned that.
Oh my goodness.
It's the beauty of like asphalt too.
That's true.
You get you around.
A little slide never hurt
anyone. That type of asphalt right there is such good flat ground, dude. Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. Good.
That's the type of flat ground me and you first played skate on back in Kansas City. It was like a brand new. I remember it was a brand new parking lot. And that's
so perfect.
It's the best when you get
dude,
that.
It destroys your clothes if you're wearing white. But
dude, your
still,
white wheels, if you land primo, done.
And like, I don't even care though, because it's so good.
Yeah.
You know? I used to skate this skate park in Laguna Hills. And the parking lot was like buttery. Mm-hmm. And I would literally just skate the flat ground and not even skate the park. Then they redid the freaking ground for no reason. ruined it, and I just never skateboarded.
It's all soft and whack.
It was the worst, dude. I'm like, come on, man. And they did it in front of my house, too, where I grew up. It was the worst.
Fuck my shit up.
Yeah.
This shit was so dope.
Yeah. So dope.
Quick transfer, dude.
But also to take that.
Yeah, not even a quick transfer. That was,
he ollied, like, look at this.
What is going on here?
Like, that would mess me up. That would mess me up.
Like, how do you go that fast at something like
that? And it's like what? Skinny. It's like a skinny ledge.
He went up at first, right? Without heating up.
Look at that, Dubs. Look.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
He barely got on and then had to go through that kink.
Yeah.
It's like he used the kink to get him set up for. I don't know. It doesn't make sense. And he did it twice.
Cookie don't know.
Are you kidding me?
That. I saw that all over Instagram.
How good did he do that?
He did it at a Drawing's bully free zone, too.
This reminded me of like Girl and Chocolate, like together in like some like shit I like seen with us. Mm. He like now. Right. He took it to like now.
Yeah.
And he fucking flipped into it.
And out of that shit.
Wow. It was a Rick Howard clip.
Right. Yeah. And then like mixed with some Kenny, with some guy, mixed with some shit.
For
like,
sure, especially on the bank to bench.
On the bank to bench shit. No
dude.
No touch.
Yeah. Wow. On some Tony Ferguson as well.
Yes. Ooh.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, dude, the first time I see anyone do the Nolly Front Heel Fakie 5-0 was Enrique Lorenzo randomly.
Ooh, that's a good one too.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Now, I didn't understand.
Yeah, this was dude, like.
Tailside hard flip, and it just.
You couldn't have done it any cooler looking.
Exactly.
It was like, did it better than actually doing it. I don't know if that makes sense. He like shifted it some weird
Strangely enough, it does make sense. Yeah.
It does, actually, Kelly.
Because it's not like a hard flip, but it's a hard flip.
It's a hard flip, but it's almost is like he could have spun it around.
He could have reverted it.
Did a big spin on that for sure.
And I feel like that would have been too much. I mean, that would have been incredible.
That would have been insane.
Yeah,
but the way he like stopped it and then just landed bolts,
it showed so much more control.
It made it look a little weird.
I like the way he did that.
Not weird in a bad way, but weird in like a wow. What the hell was that?
It was one of those things where you see like a full foot hard flip, if that makes, like when somebody's got their full foot on it and they hard flip it that way, it was like the slow flip in rotation, but it made sense.
Yeah.
Dude, it's amazing because he caught it towards the end and made it make sense to come out straight and have that roll away so successfully.
Right.
Well, that was what's so weird about it. When I first saw it, I didn't even recognize what it was.
Yeah.
I had to watch it like eight times and be like, oh, it's hard flip.
Yep.
I will say, I kind of wish that it was reversed. I wish the other trick was last and this was the second one. That's just me.
Hmm. Oh, this was like kind of just not, you weren't expecting.
Yeah.
This is something different. You know, the other trick was just like a really cool
tech
trick. You're like, wow, sick. This is like, what the fuck?
You're right.
No, hey. I'm not trying to argue anyway.
No, I'm arguing.
Okay.
Hey, good stuff, Chris Colbourn, man. Yeah. Keep it
coming.
And the acting and all the singing.
Dude. I was going to say, and the song. Too. Yeah. Like, I could see myself just listening to the song.
That
like,
shit was dope as fuck.
Cobra Man.
Yeah,
Cobra Man. Dude, Chris Colbourn. Keep
Look
doing
at Cookie
your thing,
on the
bro.
Piano, though.
I know.
Oh, the whole kid was so funny, dude.
With his Chris Roberts unkept beard. Okay.
Yeah.
the definitive line between his hair color and his beard color.
Like, oh, wow. Yeah.
It's like pouring milk into coffee.
Oh, wow. A little creamy.
She's got a red skull in her hand.
Oh, shit.
I didn't even realize that.
I like the skit aspect of it.
Totally,
you know what I mean?
I love
skateboarding.
That.
You know what I mean? If you really go back in history,
I mean that's
see.
the was it Warble Warbly?
Warble? Oh yeah, Warble.
That I mean that's their vibe. I mean that's why it falls in the line with the man ramp stuff. Yeah.
Ooh.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
I hear this. I hear it.
A lot of little scissors I used for that one.
You did some work there, Kelly.
Little scissors.
Oh!
Don't honorable
mention. Are the winners picking themselves?
Put that back in the bucket, Dubs.
It's in there.
Put that back in the bucket.
All right, leaving that one out.
We'll pick all three of us, okay, Eldy?
Thanks, dude.
Okay.
Justin Eldbridge.
Eldbridge, yeah. Dude. I'd like to go over there and hang out with those guys.
Boy,
man.
Fuck, dude.
Okay, I'm going to just pick one. Boom. I got one. Go ahead, Dubs.
Boom.
There's a winner for the... But by the way, while Dubs is... Go ahead, Dubs. Pick them, and then I'm going to remind people. Got ahead of myself right here. Eldridge, you got one?
Got one.
Quick
okay.
win.
Hey, love that. I will remind people that this episode going on right now, the super chat donations coming in will all be put in a bucket for next week. We'll pick three winners for the Nine Club Mystery Box. The Nine Club Mystery Box could have, has a couple boards in it. Some are signed. We don't know by who.
Kelly.
Sweaters, hats, stickers, grip tape, et cetera, et cetera. Man.
Heavy, heavy.
12 pounds about. I'd say about 12, 13 pounds.
At least, dude, at least.
That's a good one.
That is huge.
It's a nice big one.
Nice big one. I love 69.
There he is.
Oh.
Okay, so that's next. That's next episode. We will pick. And what we just picked right here, Dubs, Eldridge, myself, we picked winners for the Street Plant Tony Hawk thing.
Buttery little package.
We got some things going on here.
A lot of signatures going on in this week's raffle.
A lot of signatures. Yeah. We got a 3-time signed Tony Hawk 1 and 2 pro skater game.
Yes.
And 3 Street Plant boards. So each winner will receive a shirt, a game, and a board.
That's buttery.
Here, I like your little setup there, Dubs.
Thank you.
Making it look all nice. Elders never does shit like this. I like it.
Never will.
There we go. All right. Here we go. The winners.
Yes.
I'll read mine first, man. Pushing Plywood. Pushing Plywood. He wrote $2 holla.
Ooh.
Ooh. $2 holla holla.
Let me holla at you, bitch.
Holla. Holla.
And we got JB. With Kelly is getting ripped.
Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
Kelly had the guns out last episode.
I had to bring them out.
I had to bring them out.
This is JB, J space B. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, LD. What do you got?
I got Taylor Green.
Taylor Green.
Fucking nothing.
Yeah.
Oh, that's all so sad.
I know, man.
He's
Listen,
won.
Thank you so much, Taylor Green.
Thank you so much, Taylor.
Yeah.
Green.
Forgot to give the winners an applause.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much for donating. Pushing Plywood, $2 holla. Taylor Green, nothing. JB, Kelly is getting ripped.
Hey.
He did have the guns out last time.
He did.
It was display. A gun show over here. I was scared.
Oh, man.
They were on display.
I'm glad he had them on safety. I was a little nervous.
He was a little off-putting.
I had like layers on over here, and you had fucking...
I wonder about the Mitchell Ness stuff. You know what I mean? Because the homie hooks it up.
He does.
The homie... I know his name's Matt, but what were you...
Dave?
Yeah, Dave. There's all these people you started naming off that one episode.
Pushing Plywood, Taylor Green, and JB, email us contest@thenineclub.com. Send a screenshot of your receipt of your super chat donation so we know that it's you. Send us your address. And you know what? We have a large XL. What is that? A large. Put your shirt size. You know, if it is going to be what it is, if we don't have your shirt size, you're either going to get a large, extra large, large, but put your shirt size in there because you may be a large. You'll get the large. If you're a large and we send you the XL, we don't want to send you the XL, we send you the large. But we send you the large, it's the XL. But we send you the XL, we want to be the large.
What if they're okay. small?
They're out of luck.
Okay.
Double XL?
It wasn't even
Nah.
Hey, Chris, really quick, can you throw out a fart for me real quick?
I didn't even. Oh.
Got to make sure you get in there. You know, that's all I wanted.
Dude,
oh,
just man, one?
Just Kelly, one for the, just one.
Kelly's description last week.
Oh, yeah. That was good. That was good, Chris.
That was good. I mean, couldn't go an episode without
I missed
it,
the whiskey steezes.
Oh, wait a minute. You, sorry to interrupt. You caught that.
Clearly he didn't.
Oh, no, I didn't understand that. There wasn't a fart in there.
What?
Is that what it was?
Oh, the Kelly, your title last week was like, play the fart sound.
I know that. Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay.
And there was a fart
yeah.
sound in there.
Yeah, but was that because there wasn't a fart in the episode? Or did you
yeah.
Okay, that's
and
why.
Because you talk shit on me at the end of the show, so I had to have the last laugh.
Oh, of course.
My farted.
Yeah.
Salads for breakfast with some heirlooms. Boom.
It's important.
Hey, congratulations. Congratulations to the winners. Like I said, email us contest@thenincesclub.com. Send a screenshot of your receipt. Send us your shirt size and your address all in one email, and we'll get all this stuff out to you, man.
Congrats.
Definitely. Dron, you want to take us out with anything? What do you got?
Well, again, going back to me being budget on me saying that what Adidas and Lucas Puig did was wrong, I just want to say sorry. That's what I got to say.
I don't think you need to apologize, though, because we were just having a discussion.
We were just having a discussion. We were, but it's, you know.
That was
amazing.
What the hell was that about?
If we were in control, that would be a soundbite.
Oh, that dude, was a half was, yawn,
yeah.
Half.
Yeah, it was kind of like, I'm tired.
I mean, whatever. That's no, pretty much my
hey,
gig.
No, man, you're an honest man. You can admit when you made a mistake.
Yeah, that's definitely, all it was. I mean, the first person to come out and say, yeah. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And good. I was wrong.
I like the fact that we just talked about it and then people went out to prove it. Like, you know, like they made edits. Someone sent you a picture
the fucking
of a
diagram,
map,
yeah, or, yeah,
of a loop.
That's
like,
amazing.
Because I'm sure other people were
of course.
Yeah.
This but we got praise. The platform.
Yeah, let's go.
Listen, we just created just another discussion. Yep. You know, yeah, we just and people furthered the discussion. Yeah. You know,
yep.
And directed it at Dubs, which directed it at all.
Actually,
of us.
They didn't direct it at Dubs. Yeah, right?
We were getting the smoke.
Y'all.
Huh?
Yeah, you guys.
But this is the funny thing is when you go back, it is all about us. It came from this platform. So yes, I guess we are all at fault. But I said it, and I'm taking accountability. So yeah,
we are taking accountability.
We are.
1,000%.
1,000%.
What about you, Eldy? Anything to add before we head out of here, man? We got to go.
Wow.
Chris is like, yeah. Checking out. Well,
no, please, go ahead.
I got some deep shit real quick. I was thinking about this today, and I just want to address that what we perceive on social media is so not real life in some retrospect. And it's just like, okay, this is where I'm going with this. Is like, okay, me and my lady had a fight today and we were fighting on some shit. And, you know, we've been married for a year and a half and, it's hard, you know what I mean? Like on Instagram, we may look like we chilling, like we're doing our thing, but in the grand scheme of life, like it's really hard to be happy. Like that's not a thing that like, if you look at us, like we're all bullshitting, we're all happy. We're fucking doing our thing. That shit is not easy. And for all the people looking at us or looking at these Instagram models or looking at, you know, all this shit going on social media, it isn't a thing that just happens. Like we're not all just happy and all this shit. So I guess what my message is, and this is a message that I just said to myself today, is it's something that you really have to try at to be happy. Like that's like an everyday fucking thing. Like it's not gonna just happen. So if you really put your mind into being happy, It's a fucking like working out your muscles. It's working out, you know, it's going in, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that's just, that's, I don't know. That's what my message is, just like it, happy ain't doesn't come easy. It's just, it's work. It's putting every single day and focus into that. So just, yeah, it ain't going to come easy. We're all happy all the time. So just know that, and it's a process.
Totally.
Yeah. I think to add to that too is, you know, you brought up social media, and I think it's a very valid point. Social media is not real life.
It's
not.
You can't
compare your behind the scenes to other people's highlight reels, because right. That's all social media is. We're putting our best foot forward. We're putting the things out there that we want to see,
right.
or that we want other people to see and to believe about us. And I think that's why I'm such a such an advocate for, you know, being vulnerable and allowing people to see certain sides that may not necessarily be the happiest or the most, you know, glorified or glamorous. Because mm-hmm. I think allowing yourself to be vulnerable is one of the strongest things you can do. Yeah. And to you saying, you know, like, I have to take this into myself. I have to say that as well, because you and your lady had a disagreement. I think that's important to not only understand that you have those moments where you have to kind of go within and sort of like reassess what you're dealing with and what you're going through, but also be aware of what other people might be perceiving, and having that, like, the balance of knowing that just because someone views you a certain way or sees certain, you know, things within you that could be perceived as happiness or having it all together, exactly, doesn't mean that that's how you're living or how you have mm-hmm. to, you know, sort of hold up to.
And I'm a people person. Like, I literally value what people think about me, which might be like, you know, maybe it can be construed as a bad thing or whatever, a flaw, whatever. But like, I care about what people think. You know what I mean? To a certain respect, like, I don't really, I don't give a fuck what you think. But at the same time, I kind of do, because I respect you.
It depends on who's throwing whatever at you.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, look, I am not the happy-go-lucky LD that you see, LD's pick, da-da-da-da-da. I have, like, it's not all that.
Well, you're human.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we're all human, yeah.
Exactly. And it's just like, I think that, like, a lot of shit gets construed with social media, obviously. And I just, that's why I like to see, I just want to address it. And like, yo, we're human. We're fucking kicking it. We all try to make this shit happen all buttery, but we all go through shit. And if you really just have your life focused on happy, then maybe that might, you might go there. If you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. It's tough when we're in a position that every week we got people looking at us and dissecting what we do and what we say, and then that bleeds into social media and message right. boards and all. It's
yeah,
we're still like you said, we're all human, man.
Yeah,
like this is, it's not that we're trying to put something out there to where it's like, hey, this is what we are, this is what we're saying, this is our truth, we're best buds and we're all happy. Like, no, that's not always the case. Like, we are going through our own shit as well. And sometimes, you know, like, I can speak for myself. That shit is written all over my face. I wear my fucking heart on my sleeve. You know what I mean? So sometimes we'll sit here and it's tough to fucking, like, turn it on for the camera. Because whatever happened prior to us coming here and sitting down. But I think just being honest with yourself and, you know, with what's going on, it's like, at the end of the day, man, we're all just trying to figure this shit out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, life is
easy.
Yeah, life is, it's a journey, man. And there's one quote, I know it's kind of funny or whatever, but there was a quote in the movie Deadpool, was, life is an endless series of train wrecks with brief commercial-like moments of happiness.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh, shit.
I feel like you have to sort of take all of that into consideration. Like, feelings are meant to be felt, you know, whether mm-hmm. they be good, bad, or indifferent. And I think sometimes we get lost in the concept of, if I don't feel happy right now, then what does this all mean? What am I going through? But now, if you allow those feelings to kind of flow through you and you feel them for what they are and you don't allow yourself to sulk. So if you're feeling indifferent right now, you're feeling sad or upset, allow yourself to feel that and then get back to a certain balance, whatever that might be for you. Try and find that, like, that central, you know, that level for whatever it is for you, and take things as they come, take them in stride, man. Every day is a new day to try and, you know, do something different.
Yeah.
I feel, well, if you don't have the good, you don't have the bad, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes you're like, this is really shitty right now, but, you know, I don't know. You have to feel bad to feel good. You have to understand where you, right. you know, does that make, I don't know.
Yeah. Cause that's what brings the balance. You understand what is on this side and what's on this side. So let me find a common, you know, middle ground, and that the bad makes the good feel that much higher.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
What about you, Kelly, man?
I have a little thing. Cause I have, like, my team that I work with, a lot of researchers and everything like that. They've been working on finding this information that I got.
Got a team.
Yeah. I got a
what?
Team.
What? What happened?
Thing.
I
left it good earlier.
Yeah. Okay. I want to share this with you guys. Cause this is something that has been, you know, a thing now between me and Tony Hawk about the varial flip and the shove it kick flip. I have gotten
a shove it kick flip.
Okay, you might have this as a soundbite after this, because this is pretty good. This is Tony Hawk speaking. This is like a trick tip thing from Tony Hawk that's on YouTube. And let me see if I could play it.
Dude, if he gets him right now.
Oh, man.
Wait, do you mind? Wait,
I got your button, player.
Thanks, dog.
Okay. If he gets Tony Hawk right now.
Yeah.
Well, don't play the whole video.
No, it's only 18 seconds.
A barrel kickflip is a kickflip and a shove it all at once.
So he's saying, sorry, he's saying that it, a varial, he's saying, he called it a varial flip, and he's describing it as a kickflip and a shove.
I was like, you got Tony right
and
now.
And it has him doing a varial flip on it. And it hit Tony Hawk's name, Eric Costin's right next to him to verify it. So.
Wow.
Wow. Digging is a for shove information.
Kickflip.
He called it a varial flip. And he did it.
Wow.
And he put it on YouTube, a video of it.
Wow.
Wow.
You've got a solid team of researchers.
Well, yeah. It was Kyle, that's, you know, Kyle's denied.
Yeah.
That's my number one guy team right there.
the team is on 1,000
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, 1,000.
Yeah, man.
He went and sent that
my
to me.
My dude.
Tony Hawk called it a varial flip and goes back on his word and calls it a varial flip. A shove flip. Just that despite what we all know, he taught us.
Yep.
He taught us
yep.
that wow. in that video.
Absolutely right.
And now he's trying to make us feel like we don't know what it's called and we're nuts. Bro.
Kelly.
Tony Hawk, you Kelly got some explaining to do.
Kelly done his
you
work.
You got some explaining.
He done did his work, you know?
Okay. Explaining to do.
Wow.
Just want to throw that out there.
He's like playing with it, dude. He doesn't care.
Well, hey, good stuff, Kelly, man. And your team of researchers and everything. I'm sure this will come up in future episodes. I'm sure this is not done yet. You know, I don't think it'll ever be done.
Kelly, you got him good. Yeah. You got him good.
You dug
got
in the crates.
When I saw that video, it was like 1 in the morning. I got up. I was like,
oh. That's amazing.
All right, Kelly. Well, hey, good stuff, man.
Good stuff.
Hey, thank you.
Research is on
Thanks,
point.
Thanks, Kyle. Yeah.
Research is on
You're
point,
the man, man. Kyle. Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I can't wait to hear what Tony Hawk has to say.
Yeah, we did. We need a rebuttal. 24 hours, please.
It's, man.
Hey, I'm not saying that Tony Hawk's right or wrong. It's just explain to us why you're telling us two different things. And then, you know.
It's a generational thing, though.
But he describes it as.
But he's talking to Costin there. Costin is, you know, varial flipper.
That makes no sense. Yeah. I'm with Kelly. That makes no sense.
Neither does this one.
Got him.
Sal's for breakfast with some heirlooms. Boom.
Did you have something to add?
Oh, I thought, I'm sorry. I thought you were.
No, I thought from now on we were going to go like Kelly last.
that was really amazing.
I learned my lesson.
Clearly you did it, but now maybe.
But has Tony Hawk learned his lesson, though?
Nah.
Oh, man. Actually, good. I do. I know that's probably the
go ahead
going
please,
out.
Please, please.
I just want to show some love to the homegirl Jocelyn and Mike Metcalf at 9-5 and Arts and Rec. They showed me love this week and sent me a nice little care package.
Lord.
And yeah, I just wanted to spread the love. So thank you guys for that. And yeah, just Tony Hawk, man. What the fuck?
Yeah.
We need another soundbite from Tony Hawk. Like an apology of some sort would be nice. Man, maybe some flowers or something. I don't know.
Wow.
An edible arrangement.
Yeah, something nice like that would be cool.
Rip it up.
Oh, there you go.
Dude, shout out.
Eli Reed,
man. Yes. He's killing it. He's doing his thing, bro.
Oh, my God, bro.
I love it.
Entertaining as hell.
I love it. All right, man. Rest in peace, Keith Hufnagel.
Rest in peace.
As you will be missed.
Yep. Forever.
Yes.